All right, we're actually gonna, it actually started already. All right. Okay, guys, if you're watching me, if you can see us right now, me and Dark Wolf are here and we are just chilling. We're gonna look at some evidence and we're just hanging out. This video will not be listed on my channel. Hopefully we can get it on Dark Wolf's channel in a day or two. So here's Dark Wolf's with me. What's up, man?
Not much, guys. How y'all doing today? Hope everybody's doing wonderful. One thing I wanted to bring up, Booney, now that we've got everybody on board. So yesterday you asked me a series of questions that were posed to the team. And the first question I do remember, it was, why is it that we're on one side of the sun and we've got a certain view of stars and we see these stars? And then the later part of the year, say that's in winter, later on in summer, we're on another side of the sun.
Exactly.
And we can see another set of stars. So why do we see the same stars no matter what side we're on? Like a lot of people, they'll see the Big Dipper, the Little Dipper, Cassiopeia in the north, and a couple others they'll see all year round. And then others they won't. Like Orion, I found out, you can only see him in the winter. In the summertime, he is behind the sun. And I can verify that. I look for him all the time. He's my favorite.
Well, yeah, me too. Exactly.
We can actually spot, you know.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, that was the question we kind of postulated. We had question number one. We revolve around the sun. We revolve. And then when we get to certain points, should we see the same sky or should we see a different sky? Because we were sent this question. And I want to make sure we try to, let's, you know, brainstorm and maybe answer this the best way we can. So I didn't come up with anything. The more I looked, the more confused I got today. That's why I thought we'll do a hangouts and we'll just try to talk about that and all the other questions. I got like a bunch more questions I'll bring up as we go. And then we'll try to figure this out together and we'll just have some fun. So,
see, this has been in my head all day because, you know, I've thought about this and I've thought about this. Yes, you can see both dippers year round. Well, I went to Reddit. I did a YouTube search for this particular question. We're not the first ones to ask this question by any means.
Good.
So I ended up on Reddit, and what Reddit said, which made a lot of sense to me, is stars like the Big Dipper, Little Dipper, Cassiopeia, the Southern Cross is one of them for the Southern Hemisphere. You can see these all year round because they're outside of the plane of our solar system.
Okay.
So we're not just locked into this one circle. We can kind of see up and down and out and across. You know what I mean?
Yeah. So that was the scientific answer, kind of like it's outside of the solar system. So we should see this is what basically they're saying, right?
Yes, that's exactly what they're saying.
I'm just trying to follow it here.
So that was probably the best answer I got for that. That's pretty much the answer that makes sense to me because we're not locked into just a certain area of playing stars. We do have up, down, left, and right.
Yeah. I'm going to bring up my canvas so that I can kind of, I guess I'll say, well, I want to just sketch it so that I understand because I just want to see it in my head. You know, I want to see it in my head and make sure I'm getting the right idea. Okay. So can you see this? Okay. Is your thing working all right?
I can see it clear as day, bud.
Oh, dude, this is awesome. We need to do this more, man. It's just fun to do this stuff, you know?
Oh, I have a blast anytime I do live streams or do my own personal videos, you know, like for the audience, for the public or whatever the case may be. Like I enjoy it. As aggravating as video making can be sometimes, and let me tell you, the universe fought me on that last one.
Oh, dude.
As aggravating as they can be, they're fun. They are so fun to do.
Yeah, man. And I know it can be hard. Like it's hard. It's like learning a whole new fucking, you know, skill set. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely. You literally are learning a new skill set because you're learning how to manipulate software opposed to hard items, you know.
Yeah, man. Oh, for sure. Okay, so look, we were doing this last night. So this is what we had last night. We had the sun's in the middle, our Earth right here, and we're going around. We're gonna act like I know it's on a tilt a little bit, but we're just going to try to do our best. There's an equator, and I just messed it up. But anyway, here's an equator. So on the day...
Australia, all right.
Well, we got something there. Okay, so look. Okay, daytime, it doesn't matter because we won't see any stars, right? Okay.
Right.
Okay, so nighttime, let's say we're chilling at this point on the Earth. Here's the night. Here's what we'd see in the night sky, right about there.
Right.
Okay.
Okay. Now, you're looking straight outwards in this angle. You're looking straight at the stars in front of you. Yeah. But also remember, this is a 2D concept of a 3D reality.
Uh-huh.
So what that by that I mean, when you're looking out, yeah, you're looking straight out at the sky, but if you turn your head down, you're looking at another set. You turn your head up, you're looking at another set. To the left, yeah. Yeah, dimensions are in it. Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
So you're seeing all these stars in this circular area here.
All right.
Up, down, left, and right. And things like the Little Dipper, Southern Cross, Cassiopeia, the Big Dipper, they're all outside of our solar system. So we're seeing those above, if you will.
Okay, okay.
Or below.
All right, now we got to let me think something here so that I make sure I don't get lost, because I get lost easy as hell when it comes to this stuff. All right, so look, we're just going to say that this is the Earth right here now. Okay, so we're chilling on a point on it. And here's the night sky all above us. Okay, so let's say the Big Dipper is like right here. All right.
Okay.
All right, all right. And then let's say...
That's a good dipper.
Thanks, dude. I've been working on this. I've been practicing. And then let's say that this is Orion right over here. There's Orion. Okay. Now, what our viewer asked us was... Okay, so we got that in our mind. Now, our viewer said, now, when we get to the other side, okay, so we had that drawing. I'm going to do a small version of it. There's the sun. Here's the Earth. Now, when we drew it last time, we were over here, and this was our view. Our viewer said that when we got over here, that we should have a different set of stars logically, because this would be our view. This would be like our view plane. So... I want to make sure I try to wrap my head around it. Let's cordon this off. Let's square this off. Okay. And then we'll draw that same one I drew. This is the Earth from a different view. This is our sky. Okay. Why would we see, let's just say Orion's like way, okay, so what if when we're on this side of the sun, let's say Orion's way over there, why don't we see a different set of stars when we look on this way? That's a good way to question it, I guess. What do you think?
Okay, that's a great way to question it. So let's think of, in the box. And in the box on the left-hand side of my screen,
uh-huh.
Where the sun and the original drawing is. Okay, mm-hmm. Right above all of that in the box, put a little bitty Big Dipper.
At the very top of it?
Yeah,
like
inside the lock.
Inside
yeah,
the box.
Yeah, that'll work.
Okay, no, so we'll say it's inside the box. It's like right over here, you know.
Yeah. So no matter looking at, you're still going to see it above. See what I'm saying?
No matter where we're looking at, no matter if we're on this side, because of the fact that, like, when we're on the right side diagram, we're always seeing everything like a 3D panoramic kind of view. Is that what they were saying? It's kind of
yes.
Like that kind of. You're going to see every little detail. That kind of gets me, man. That question does get me right there. That's the spot where it gets me. I would
right.
think it would be a little different. Well, a lot different, not just a little, like they say. It'll be like completely different. But I see what you're saying.
And this still bothers me too. Don't get me wrong. I'm still trying to run it through my head, and I'm explaining it as I'm understanding it. So,
okay, there it is. Why don't we see different stars in the summer than in the winter?
Yes.
Okay, it says on Google, so let's just think about this for 1 second. We see constellations at different times of the year, spring, summer, fall, winter. This occurs because the Earth is orbiting the sun. In winter, we see the constellation Orion in the south night sky. And during the day, the sun is in a sky with the constellation Scorpius. Okay. I don't know what to think about that explanation. They got a whole bunch of different ones, though.
Like I said, red is the one I found. I thought that was the most clear one.
Well, we'll take a look-see over at the good old Reddit, I guess. Okay, so that one's trying to tell us Okay, now, if you look at the night sky at different times in the year, you see different constellations due to the motion of the Earth. So this is saying that we are going to see completely different. But see, that's the thing that my viewer said to me. My viewer said that they go outside, they sit down. Oh, spelled it wrong. My viewer goes outside, sits down, and watches the sky every night. It's just something this guy does. So that's why he was kind of like freaking out, because he was seeing it rotate, but he wasn't seeing a completely different sky.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Now, as for the smaller stars, I don't really pay a lot of attention to those. I'm more of a constellation looker myself. So
if
he's paying a deeper attention to that, he might have something I haven't seen. But I challenge the viewer or the questionee to show me Orion in the summertime. If you can point out Orion in the summertime, I will gladly relent.
Exactly. Okay. So let me write this down, because I'm serious. We're not just one of those channels that's just going to act like we answered the question. We're really going to mail the viewer. We're going to let him challenge what we just thought, and then we'll see what he says in a night or two, and we'll come back with something. You know what I mean? We'll figure it out from there. So it'll be a back and forth thing. All right. Okay. So what? Okay. Well, the second question last night. What was the second question?
See, that one I don't remember. I got so stuck on the first question. I'll be honest. I didn't remember the other two.
Thank you, dude. No, I did. I did also. But okay. So I'll remember it. You're right, dude. I got them probably right in front of me. Okay.
Because I remember us mentioning writing these down in case we did forget them.
Nope. And I did it. It's right there. See now. It's good you remember this stuff, because I'd be lost right now. So you need help sometimes, right? We're a team here at Uni Rock and Dark Wolf's Den. Okay, number two was, now, we talked about this last night. We actually talked about this today. You've been at work, but I talked about it with Dr. Lupo a little, and we had a panel, but there's a star. When we look at the moon, there's a star a little bit up to the right. Okay, so do you remember me bringing that question up yesterday? It was about a star near the moon?
Yes, I do remember this.
Okay. I wanted to make sure I told you the same one that I had written down, because sometimes I do that too. I'll say something completely different than I wrote down. I just confuse the hell out of you sometimes. I have to, man. Okay. Well, here we go.
I only laugh because same thing when I'm making notes, and I'll go back through my notes on what in the world was I trying. I know what I was trying to say.
Exactly. All right. So this is our view. This was our question number two. Is this? We've talked about it with several smart minds. We're bringing it to you now. We've got the moon. When I looked at the night sky, I walked outside and looked up. I saw the moon, and I saw this star, and it just intrigued me. In fact, so many people have confirmed this also. It's all over the United States, at least. I didn't ask anyone in England yet. I'm going to. That's our other, main team members are over there. So, we've got this to this, okay? Why is this star moving with the moon and not moving with the other stars? That's the question. We do have some theories, though.
A lot of people say, now a lot of people when you bring this up will say it's Venus, because that gets a lot of credit in the media. It's Venus or it's Mars. That's another one. It's Mars. Mars is moving with the moon. I don't know my horoscopes that well to tell you which house Mars is in and Sagittarius is in and this and that, you know.
Oh, no. We might have a way to find out. I have a program, but I don't really know how to use it that well, but we'll look at it in a little bit. So, yeah, theory number one was it's a planet.
Right.
I think we can disprove that theory pretty fast, because it moves in relation to the moon. And I have video of this. I don't have tomorrow or the next night, our next broadcast, I will show that video. I'll load it in. It's on my phone, but it does move with the moon. Now, it could ironically, let's just say that once every 6,000 years, one of the planets follows an orbit that just looks like it moves with the moon. I'm sure that will be one excuse that will come up, just trying to predict a little.
Okay, when the viewer asked this, let me ask, did they mention how soon this started happening, or if this is a new thing, or?
Well, reportedly, we've only gone back about maybe a week to 10 days. I am not saying that is how long it's been happening, but that's the most reported we've got going on. You know what I mean? That's what we've heard. So.
Gotcha. So this is the most recent data, is about a week ago. It definitely came into somebody's realization.
Mm-hmm.
Gotcha.
This one stumps me, man.
Well, I'm going to go over here on my phone and ask our best friend Google.
All right, go. You do that, because Google is YouTube. Let's go. While you look that up, I want to say, if you do need to make a search on the internet, use Google. They use algorithms, and they have a lot of time doing this search engine stuff. They're the ones to use. UniRock, supported by Google. Actually, they are, so it's a good thing I'm plugging them. So. They pay the bills around here.
Great. Yeah, Google, yeah, for real. If it wasn't for a lot of their products, there's a lot of stuff me and you as video creators even couldn't do.
Oh, for sure.
I don't have YouTube.
Good add-in. That's good. You've got to plug them too, so good job.
Absolutely. Go Google. Anyway, we're actually getting a Google in our town really soon. I just found this out.
Oh, damn. Hell yeah, dude.
So I went to type this into Google.
All right.
Just to throw the name out there one more time for everybody. And you know how it's got the auto ending or auto correct or whatever they call it?
Uh-huh.
Well, they do a lot of videos, you know, funny auto endings. Well, here's one that I got first off. What is the star that is close to the moon tonight?
Really? It said that when you typed it in?
Yeah, first thing.
Oh, damn. So other people are searching this too, or that wouldn't have come up.
Especially not as the first one.
Awesome, man. Okay.
Okay, so here's what Google says about it. And I quote, in their outward order from the sun, the five bright planets are Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter, and Saturn. These planets actually do appear bright in our sky. They are typically as bright as or brighter than the brightest stars. That is not an answer.
No. No way, Google. Google, you're cool and all, but you're not helping.
Yeah, they didn't do that one too well. They basically, here's the bright stars. We don't really know. That's pretty much them saying they don't know, I would say.
I think you're right, man. I think you're right. So that's why we're going to take this question for Google, and we're going to answer it and send it to them. And I'm not even joking. I know some people over there, and I will send it straight to them. My cousin actually works there. Okay, well... this is a problem. So let's go with possible. Let's brainstorm. That is one of the main things we do to get to a solution. Let's brainstorm. So we've got the moon and the star. Number one was planets. What would number two be?
Okay, so I'm going to go full woo for number two. Some kind of ship following, trying to hide and not doing very well.
So we're just going to write UFO, right?
Yes.
Now, that'll be UFO with a ship, because just possibly we may get to a answer that has something else that could be an object, and I want to make sure we differentiate.
Okay, I'm glad you said that, because there's another object it could very well be. If we have a comet or a meteor that's large looming in our plane, then we could see that as in a very slow movement. And if it just happened to be right there next to the moon, that's where it happens to be. Yeah. I don't know if it's the same trajectory, but BP Earthwatch earlier plug just threw a video up about accidental plug just threw a video up about the incoming object. He calls it the thingy. I thought that was so funny. The thingy.
gotta have thingies. Hey, I was about to say when. That's why I keep you on here, man, because you know this stuff. You keep current with this. I read earlier today that NASA has an article that says they took pictures of a comet or some other, you know, meteor-like object that just missed the Earth, not just missed, but passed the Earth recently, and they took pictures of it. So that when you said that, that's the first thing that popped in my mind. Hey, NASA just said this too.
Right. It very well could be. And again, I've seen, well, remember when they were showing years ago, I don't remember if it was live or on TV, but they showed Comet coming in. I want to say it was live Like, I was watching it, but I can't remember, so I'm not going to say it was or wasn't.
Yeah.
But I remember it took, like, forever. It looked like it was just a still frame.
Yeah.
Even though it was moving, it was almost like it was caught in time, because from our perspective, it's not moving all that fast.
Uh-oh, it's coming up. Comet passes the Earth. We'll say in April. Maybe that'll get us there. We're having a hard time pulling this up, man. I don't know. Well,
it's almost like they really don't have a good answer for it.
Oh, Wednesday. NASA. Asteroid and comet fly close by Earth Wednesday. We got it. Let's pull her up here. We'll take a look.
Right. And where is this article, just for the sake of knowledge?
All right. We actually, they had it on NASA's webpage, but the one we're looking at is from stgeorgeutah.com. So it's some type of news agency. Let's go ahead and
play. Okay, so it is a news agency. Gotcha.
It's not one of the tabloids. I know that much, because it's Utah. Most of the tabloids are dailyukfakenews.com. So you know what I mean.
Okay. Oh, yeah, absolutely.
You may hear some sound here. But let's hope some sound comes through. I don't know about the sound. Okay, look, can you see it? That's the comet.
I see it. That's the trajectory.
That's
where are we
close
in this? It's a little grainy on my end.
Yeah, let me try one more time. Let me blow it up for you.
Okay, there we go. Now, where are we at?
We're on the right side of the screen.
Okay.
Okay, well, so it's a comet 2014 J025. It looked like, I could have been a little bit wrong there. That's what it looked like to me, though, when I saw that. Well, maybe we're going to go ahead and say that I don't. Now, you saw the trajectory there. It moved completely from one side of the plane there to the other side of the screen, which would mean this couldn't be our object.
Fair enough, because it's following our moon.
Exactly. Well, okay. At least let's get
next to the moon. You know, who's moving, us or the moon?
Oh, yeah. I don't know anything anymore. Things have been getting crazy lately, buddy. You know what I mean?
Oh, man, about 2 years ago when my perception decided that everything in reality that I remember is no longer real. Yeah, I know what you mean.
Yeah, I know, buddy. Okay, so.
Okay, go ahead. I ain't gonna rant on the Mandela effect. I almost went on an Emmy rant.
Oh no! Hey, a lot of our viewers like it when we talk about it. Let's go ahead and take a second. Go ahead, man.
Well, you know, you're talking about getting crazy. The weirdest moment of my life was when I found out that Berenstain was not Berenstain; it was Berenstain. And in my videos, I always point to that. And I'm sure people are sick of hearing me say that particular example, but understand, I learned to read on these books. If there's anything that I would have bet money on, that was one of those things.
Yeah, I'm with
just
you.
One of those childhood experiences that you know. It just, yeah. You can't take that away from somebody. And then when I go back and look at reality and see it's always been an A, like I can't wrap my head around this. My reality literally changed. And from there, yeah, craziness just become a way of life, I think, at that point.
Yeah, man. Okay, before we go back to the viewer questions, this was an interesting video that was on YouTube today. It was the world's first 360-degree rocket launch, and I watched this live. Let me go ahead and mute it. Okay, it's muted. Now, now this is the interesting thing that I saw about this rocket launch. It's showing us from the ground. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
I wanted to see it from the rocket.
Oh, it's not 3D from the rocket?
Well, look, I'll skim through. Okay, so it's about 13 minutes long. Now, you can see the pole in the background and everything out here. Now, let me scoot up. Okay, still there. All right, that's like half in. Let's go to the three-quarter mark. And look, something's smoking over there. Hold on. Is it launching? Yeah.
Well, you know you can turn the screen if it's 3D, right?
Oh. Whoa! Oh, shit. Dude, I'm so glad you told me that. I didn't know. That's awesome.
Yeah, the funny thing about those, even on Android, you can do the same thing. They say you can turn the camera on Android. I've never had a phone that actually would, like, you turn the phone and it turns. I've always had to turn.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
They say you're supposed to do that. I've never experienced it.
That's pretty awesome. Well, look, we're at the 12-minute mark, and it hasn't even launched yet. Oh, whoa, it just disappeared. Let's go back. Oh, let's just watch this take off, and we'll go back and get back on topic. But, oh, here it goes. Let's watch this thing launch real quick. I'll go ahead and bring it up. All right, can you see it okay? Oh, and there it goes. Whoa!
Wow, that was quick.
It was in one frame. One frame, that thing just took off like a bat out of hell.
It was there, then it wasn't.
That's craziness.
Holy cow.
Fast. I love watching that stuff, though. YouTube, NASA stuff. Remember, last night we spent some time looking at a NASA ISS live feed. Saw some real interesting stuff. We'll have to bring that up later if we get to it.
The stuff I saw on there was incredible, like absolutely incredible. Stuff I never thought I'd see on the live feed. Like, that was crazy.
Right, it was. We're going to break that video down together in one of our shows here. Because we're going to start doing this show anytime we have time. Are you off on the weekends? Are you working on weekends?
Okay, so they can only make us work two Saturdays a month. So the other two Saturdays are free regardless. I haven't been working lately, but we are starting to pick up and getting in more into peak season. So it'll probably be like every other Saturday I'll have free or something along those lines. Two a month either way.
That's perfect. Hey, that's perfect. We'll go ahead and.
I got every Sunday though.
Hey, we'll start doing it on Sundays for sure. That'll be a good day to have like a big show, like we'll put it together. It won't be like a non-topical show. We'll actually put it together on Sunday. So, you know.
Right. Have a full set of ideas and flow all the way through, segue to segue.
Yeah, because we're like just doing our viewer questions, and that's important. You know, people want to get their questions answered. I'm going to pull up my email in a little bit, and we'll look through there once we get done here. Okay, wait. Well, so we're on the star on the moon. So I think we've ruled out that comet. Now, let's just, like, they didn't even see that one till the last minute, you know?
Right.
So
that's still not out of the realm of possibility that it could be a comet.
I wanted to make sure you were with me there, so let's just write down comet. And comet,
oh,
asteroid,
I'm 100%
whatever.
With you on that.
All right, so we got to come up with five. So let's just go, we're on four.
Right. Well, I've got three, it's your turn.
Okay. Okay, now. So we'll go with a popular viewer answer on this one. And I know they did say planet, they did say UFO. Those are just obvious. Comet's a good one to have in there. Another one we could probably put as a likely candidate, let's just say it's an optical illusion. That's always a possibility. Although I don't think that's it.
But we do have to include the possibility just the same.
Exactly. We have to rule it all out in order to get anywhere with the scientific method. Okay. Now, we're at five. Let's, if we can't think of one in 10 seconds, we'll just go ahead and say no five. But you got anything? I'll see what I can think of.
Okay. So.
Oh, I'll check the comments. I'll see if we have any comments from viewers.
To see Jesse, because this is viewer run anyway, this whole episode is, so
yeah. Let's all ask right now, anyone have a possible object for here? I'll go ahead and put the comments into the window.
Hey, there
we go. If you can see them, okay. Anyone have a possible object for the moon star? And I think we have a 10 second delay, it might be a 4 second delay, so we'll give them a second. We'll see if our
all right, it has come up on. Okay, yeah.
It's up now.
It's come up on mine.
Okay. Hey guys, we're glad you're watching. We promise we're gonna start doing this all the time, and we're not gonna bore you, because we're pretty cool.
Paranormal said that his Android phone actually was able to just move it and do the 360 thing. So I don't know what kind of phone he has, but that one works.
All right, Salted Cedar gave us a good suggestion. He says, now, straight from the comments, our viewers are saying the Star of Bethlehem.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
And I tell you, that's such a good one because we also have a biblical alignment coming up September 23rd. The alignment of Revelation, the one that speaks of the virgin giving birth and the 12 stars bathed in the sun, moon at her feet. We have that constellation in our sky the night of September 23rd. It's Virgo. And Jupiter is coming, what looks like, out of her womb. Pleiades is at her head. I believe the way placement of the sun and moon at that time will be at her head and her feet.
Awesome. All right. And you know what? This is perfect to bring this up because I did a story on this and I'm going to work this in a little bit. So good. That's fucking awesome, dude.
Well, it's funny because I learned that when I did a story on my channel about it was the Christian's answer to it. Did the devil do it? And I actually was really intrigued when I got to look and found that everything's like lining up to where their end time possibility isn't completely out of the realm. However, there are still a couple of things that haven't happened in Revelation. So I can't say that's 100, but well, I was quite surprised at how much is lining up.
Revelation is one of my favorite books. I'm not even going to say books of the Bible. If you wanted a good story, if you wanted something that's really going to make you feel something after you read it, I don't care if you're a Christian or an atheist or any other religion, because you can pick up other books. I'm serious. Revelation is one of those things you read, and it's a good one, dude. It's such a good one. Such a good one.
Oh, yes. I've read the Book of Mormon, so you can always pick up another book. And I'm not going to rip on any religion. I ain't going to go into my rant on that one. I don't want to offend anybody. But if you do read the book, let me put it this way. If you're not a believer and you just read the book as a book and nothing more, it is an amazing book. Great stories, wonderful storyline. It is Christian-based. It is talking about Jesus a lot. It's a really great book. The stories in it are absolutely incredible. I'll give it that.
I do. I love that book. I'll tell you what. I'm going to email you after this because I've got a transcription from the Egyptian Book of the Dead or Book of the Pyramids, the pyramid texts.
Yes,
written
really?
Written in 52, transcribed in 1952. Very easy to read. He's very clear when he can't, if something seems hard to, we'll say, if a word is hard to decipher, he's very clear. So really, just a really good read. I'm going to send that to you after this so we can talk about it on a future show.
Oh, I'd much appreciate that. I'd love to read some of that nature.
So what I'm
gonna, I love the pyramid stuff, love all that. Go ahead.
Oh, exactly. So what I'm going to say, though, for answer number 5 and our problem with question number 2, if I'm making any sense, I know I'm getting out there, but question number 5 we're going to say is a religious answer to the star next to the moon, because that's what the star of Bethlehem, wouldn't that fall under a religious answer?
Yes, that would.
More broad. Okay. Okay.
I like that better. Because there are multiple nations and multiple cultures, I'm sorry, there's the word I'm looking for, that are known to talk about end times a lot like the Christians do all throughout history. So the Christians aren't the first one to come up with the end time revelation. They're just put their spin on it, but That star has appeared many, many times in stories of the ancient cultures.
You're right. And I love every ancient text. That you got to remember, our ancestors or the people before us, they wrote those. And even if it's a work of fiction, let's say the ancestors wrote a work of fiction, I would read it. I don't care if they're claiming it's a religious text or a work of fiction. Those things that are 1,000, 2,000, 4,000 years old, that's one good way to see into the past, to time travel in your mind, reading those books.
A window into what was actually going on in those people's lives at that time.
And anyone who wouldn't be interested in the people before us, I mean, what they've learned, what they saw, how their life was, just think of how different it was. And it's fascinating. It's almost like we live in a different world now with technology, with food being... You used to have to worry about food to survive. I mean, that's a game changer, right?
Oh, yeah. You ain't got to go out and have to fish to live or have to make sure you kill a deer or you and your family ain't eating tonight. That's gone by the wayside. Now the only place you go to kill a deer is to the grocery store where they already did all the work for you and packaged it.
Yeah. Yeah. And it makes, you know, it's easy to eat a lot of meat. I'm not going to say anything bad about people that eat meat or people that are vegetarians. I think you should eat what you want. But I've always wanted to eat less meat because I don't like the idea of butchering a lot. But, you know, when you go to the store and buy it, and I still do it, I just did it today. I don't mind going and buying a hamburger right now. And I wouldn't like to kill a cow, butcher it, and then have to do it that way. If it was that way, I'd probably eat more vegetables. You know what I'm saying?
Right. If I had to do it myself, I'd be a vegetarian by nature.
Thank you. At least we see eye to eye there. Okay, let's not get too, like, we can go into, we'll go off into other stuff in a minute. Let's see here.
Right.
We've got five possibilities. We've got a video of the star. Actually, I have two separate nights, two separate videos of the moon and this star. I do want to tell you a related story, though, and just see what you think. Okay, so my mom was at the house. She was over, you know, when we live streamed yesterday for a bit. She was over today. She's not here now because I'd love to have her talk about it. My mom was at the house. She says, come outside. It was night. I forget for what. She was talking to Rachel, my girlfriend, and I go outside. We're talking, and all of a sudden, it's not a full moon, but it gets so bright outside that it was like the sun came out, almost. It was like a really dim sun came out, but it was night and the moon was out. And that's when I noticed the star. It was so bright, I looked over. I pulled out my camera, and it was like I was filming the sun. It, you know, that big halo you get around the sun, that big, bright, you know. And that's what the moon did. It was so bright. And then I couldn't see the star. So while I'm filming it, maybe 10 minutes later, it all dies down, and I can see the star and the moon perfectly. So for me, this star is really cool because of just the way I was introduced to the star. It was kind of magic. Majestic, I'd say, I guess.
Good choice of words both times. Well, I can't explain crazy, that. Yeah. The moon suddenly getting brighter and brighter to block out the view of that star? Was that through your camera, or was that just
through my camera? Yeah.
Okay. No, through my your camera.
Yeah, through my eyes, it just looked extremely bright. I will say that, yeah. I'm glad you said that.
So, yeah, because I was a little confused on that myself. So I can understand a camera trying to focus in the light pattern. I know that because the way my room's set up and the way the lighting's set up, I am showered in light, but I look dark to the camera because it's trying to make the difference up for the light and the darkness. So I can understand them doing the phone acting like that. Like, that makes some kind of sense to me. You're just trying to focus, if you will, on a very bright object.
Okay. Well, so for this question, I think we've made some good progress. It's not answered yet. We are getting there, though. So I can actually mail the actually, this one came out of Discord. So I can get on Discord, talk to someone later. And I'm going to see if he'll come on tomorrow. I'm going to try. I don't know what will happen with that, but we'll see.
Is it one of the docs?
No, it's
Or do you want to throw the name out there right now?
Oh, no, I will. I will. I'd have to open Discord. You know what? In a little bit, I'll open Discord, and we'll go in there for a minute while we're talking, because I know people will be there.
Doc Michael. I'll read back through the text a little bit. I thought it was Doc Michael asking stuff like that.
Well, Doc Michael was there talking to me, and Wobbly. Wobbly was one. He was talking to me about it. Yeah.
Gotcha.
I'm going to ask Wobbly. Some people don't like to be on. Maybe he'll just do a voice thing, you know? Or maybe he'll talk to us in the comments when we do it tomorrow so I can ask him some questions while we talk. So, because that would be cool, you know?
That would be. That really would be. Get a more of a clarification of what he's trying to – or what he thinks about it so far.
Yeah, because really what he did was he had me watch a video, and then I wrote down key points. Now, the first one came – in an email also. And that's why I was like, shoot, I'm going to write this down. This is great. Now, the second one, I wrote that down. I talked to Wobbly, and he was elaborating on it with me. And I'm like, I'm going to talk to Dark Wolf about it. We're going to figure some stuff out here. Now, and the third one also was brought up a long time ago, actually, maybe 2 weeks into my channel. And that's my segue into the third question. So,
okay.
All right. Now, we are on. I'm going to go back to it. Please. I know I'm not that great of an artist, but all right. I just had to lead in with that. Okay, so here's our Earth. Those are continents. Okay, we got continents on our Earth. Now, we were talking about this a lot last night. So All right. Let's just say we're standing on the one of the continents. That's why I drew them. We're standing on right here. This is America. And, okay, I made Canada way too small, but okay. So it's let's just say it's a really let's say you're out in the woods in a clearing. It's a very dark, actually. Oh, third phase of the moon. Hey, man. Thank you. Hey, guys. Appreciate you coming on. We love your stuff here, too. I like what you guys have been doing lately. Okay.
Hey, third phase. Good to see you guys.
All right. Now, okay, so we have satellites in a clearing. Okay, we're in a clearing in the woods. Okay, we look up to the sky, and we have satellites that we see on a very clear night with a very clear sky. Okay. Lots of satellites. I see them myself. Now I haven't been in the woods at night doing camping probably for 10 years. No. What is it? 17? Yeah. Probably been more like 8 to 10 years. Now I did see satellites the last time I went camping on a clear night in the woods. You can see them go all the way across the sky. You've seen this before, right?
Yes.
Okay. Now, okay. We have an issue, and it's our viewers really like to ask about this. I am perplexed by this. I've studied facts on this. We brought it up last night, but we should be able to see satellites from the ISS station. Now, there's another huge part of this before we start talking about it. Okay, so there's so many satellites out there. Okay, that it's incredible, the number, you know, and. Let's just say the ISS station, let me clear the board. Let's just say the ISS station is, oh, I hit the wrong button. What am I doing, guys?
Let's come just on, Nooney.
I'm pulling it together. I need some more caffeine, dude. Will you get me a coffee? Okay, so we're on the ISS station. So here's the ISS. Okay, and we're on there. You know, last night when we watched this on YouTube, it was a camera. We were looking through, and we were watching it float over the Earth. Let's just draw the Earth as boom. That's kind of what it looked like, right?
That is kind of what it looked like. Sharper slope on the one side.
Now, we know we're not going to see satellites pass over the Earth under the ISS. We know that's not going to happen because the reason why is because the satellites are above the ISS. They are the ISS is in LEO. LEO, low Earth orbit, and that's between 80 and 100, and we'll just, I'm guessing, no factual information here, but 80 and 130 miles is where you're going to see low Earth orbit. That, and now the ISS should be right at the top of that, so it's in between, right at the bottom of mid-range orbit, I forget the word for that, and then there is the high orbit. So we don't see satellites below when we're looking through live feeds of the ISS, but it's a huge theory right now that we should see them over the horizon of the Earth based on where the sun is. So at least in, let's say, a handful of ISS, missions or, ISS camera, live streams, we should see at least the reflections out over the horizon of the Earth. Of some of the satellites. They're very reflective. They're so reflective we can see them from the Earth. See what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
That's the issue here. We don't see those satellites. That's one of our problems that we need to solve. So I think it'd help our viewers out. It would really help us out if we could solve this. I know it really baffles us.
Watching that live stream last night, that is one thing that did bother me. Like, we watched a good couple few minutes of it, probably good, 20, 30, maybe 40 minutes of that thing.
Mm-hmm.
We watched quite a while, and we're watching the ISS move along the horizon of the Earth steadily because, you know, it's free falling.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see a large plane out in front of you. And not at any time do we see a single flicker, reflection, light beam, anything that shouldn't have been there where a satellite would reflect off of. And like you said, there's fields and fields and fields of satellites out there. Every cable company, every channel, everything has a satellite, every GPS. There's got to be dozens of GPS for every section of the planet.
Yeah.
So there's plenty of satellites out there. We know that because our GPS works. That's not in question. However, to answer this, what worries me is where it leads to. because it brings into question, and this has gained other evidence, like I think you put out a couple few pieces of evidence on this, that the ISS may very well not really be up there.
Now that's okay. We're getting right to that point. We're going to go through we have in our scientific method, we usually use three, but we decided that on topics that are going to be kind of bigger, we're going to try for five. Let's start with one. Now, number one is NASA's explanation. We have to use their explanation on this one for explanation one. Okay.
All so right.
Number one is, what, okay, now I just hit a roadblock. What is NASA's explanation for why we do not see satellites from the live feed of the ISS over the horizon?
All right, asking our teammate right now, Google, what okay. do you say?
Now, we always turn to Google because Google is the place you go when you need information fast. Click that button, search that Google. Sorry, dude, sorry. I went on an advertising streak. I got to get this back.
Okay. Hey, people say, are they paying you? Yeah, we are creators. We monetize our stuff, so yeah, they kind of are.
they don't want me. They didn't ask me to advertise for them, but I love advertising for Google. It's just mind control. I didn't even know I was saying that, so.
Okay, hold on.
Okay.
You know the auto insertion in Google. I have to put this one out there. This is the first one to come up with, and it's so funny. Why does NASA say lock the doors?
Wait, really?
Why does NASA say lock the doors? I don't know what the answer to this is, but I thought that was one interesting autocorrect ending.
Why does NASA say lock the doors? That's Google, you're funny tonight, man.
That's one thing about Google. They got a sense of humor. Cannot see the satellites from the ISS, correct?
We cannot see satellites from the ISS. That would be a good general question to put into the Google. Let me see what I can do too, because I'll ask it a different version. Okay, yeah, here it is. Okay, now I'm gonna type in, why don't satellites? Oh gosh, I don't even know how to spell satellites, dude. My brain is. It's been a long day though. It's late, right? Is that a good excuse for why?
That's a great excuse. I'm surprised I'm not sitting here bumbling every word. I just did an 8-hour shift myself. Like I literally came in the door, got reset, and come online. So y'all get me fresh from work.
I forced you to. You said, give me a few minutes to relax. And I said, no, you're coming on now. You don't get any time. No, I didn't do that.
And I said, yes, sir. Network must live.
That's right. You're a hard worker, buddy. We appreciate you. Okay, we've got a few pop-ups from this type in. Why don't ISS photos show any of the thousands of satellites orbiting? It's on Quora. We'll look at the second one before we click. NASA live feed mysteriously cuts. Okay, so let's go on with number one because it's exactly our question. It's our viewer's question. Why doesn't ISS photo show thousands? Let's hear what they say while you look around for 2 seconds here. We got 20
answers. I'm actually on Quora myself, believe it or not. I didn't even realize that. I was scrolling through and I looked up to the top to see where I was at, and I'll be darned, I'm on the same one you're on.
All right. It says, just because the ISS is in space does not mean it is closer to other satellites than we are on the ground. 45% of the operational satellites are in orbits more than 35,000 kilometers. That would mean they're a quarter of the way to the moon if they're that high.
That's exactly what it's saying.
Wait. The moon is... Hold on, I got my numbers wrong, but I won't be happy if I just leave that like that.
And that's in kilometers, too. Remember, that's kilometers.
You're right. Okay, oh, that's why. So let's put, how far is the moon from the Earth in kilometers? All right. 38,000 kilometers. Okay, so it's more like
almost a tenth. The moon.
Well, no, I'm sorry. 384,000, and the satellites are about a tenth of that. Yeah, it's about 10 times. But here's what I want you to see. Because of that man's explanation, I want you to see what I found when I did a little research.
All right.
Third phase of moon has a really good point. Third phase said Google could still keep this answer a secret. And that I'm going to type to him. It won't come up for a few seconds. That's very true. But what I want third face to remember is I'm always going on a, I always take my videos on a strange journey. You know what I mean? Where I may, it may look like I'm asking Google so I can get Google's answer, but I know Google's not going to give me the right answer. You know what I mean?
You know, it's kind of the same reason I watch the news. I watch the news to see the lies so I can discern the BS from the truth.
Yeah. Well, third phase, I know they might have seen some of our stuff. We're new doing this part of it, the live stream. I'm so happy third phase is here, though. Thank you again for coming by, guys. Let's just say, though, okay, we typed in, okay, what I was going to type was, is okay, yeah. Let me get back on track. We're going to look at what Google says about this, and then I'll tell you why I did this. Because I'm glad Third Face said that, because it's important to know why I'm asking Google here. So how high are satellites? Oh, it's going to come right up because I typed it in last night. In the sky. There's a good one. It did put orbit, but I'm going to put in the sky. Okay, they're telling us 35,000 kilometers also. But, oh, now remember, when we just talked about this, we talked about low Earth orbit, and that's what I needed to show you. So how high is low Earth orbit? Now, hopefully it'll show us every orbit. Low Earth orbit is 99 miles, okay? Now, they're saying 99 miles. Orbital period of 88 minutes. About 1,200 miles, about 127 minutes, okay. Objects below 160 kilometers, 100 miles, basically, will experience a very rapid orbital decay and altitude loss. So they're saying that the highest you got to go so that the Earth doesn't just rip you right back down is 100 miles. That's where you have to sit so that you do not get ripped right back down, okay?
Gotcha.
Well, now, we want to know, though, also, we don't want to just know about low Earth, because we need to think about mid-Earth or medium. It'll be mid. Okay. Oh, here we go. Oh, no, it's still telling me low Earth orbit. How weird is that? Let's refresh. I don't know if it didn't just take. Huh. See, the third phase had a really good point. That's why I'm so glad third phase said that, because we just typed in how high is mid-Earth orbit, but they're still trying to tell us about low-Earth orbit. Let's go with the highest orbit.
I see this. That's interesting. Sorry, I was actually going back to the chat when you said that.
Okay. All right. Okay, so here's high. Now, I typed in high-Earth orbit. Maybe high-Earth orbit's called something else, because I know LEO is the anagram for low-Earth orbit, so I might have my anagrams wrong, but let's just see this. For elliptical orbit, see highly elliptical orbit. That's really not what we want to look at. To scale a diagram of low, medium. Oh, wait, we got a diagram. This is going to be freaking perfect, man. Tell me you can see this, okay? It's too small.
I can see it.
Hold on, let me get it bigger for you.
I want you to see what's on the screen.
Let's get it bigger for you. Okay, that's good.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Oh, tell me that's better. Is that better?
That's gorgeous.
We even can see where the ISS is. This is why this is cool right here. Okay.
I need you to save that.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I'll save this one and I'm going to put it in our Google Drive. I'm going to start putting our info back in the Google Drive. We haven't used it in a while, but I'm going to do that for us. Okay.
That sounds great. That'd be a good, you know what? That'd be a good way to share these videos where I can get a hold of them and go ahead and drop them. Instead of having to download the downloader.
And I want to make sure I'm going to say this now. If you do want to go back and watch parts of this video, these streams that I do with Dark Wolf are going to be on his channel. We are going live from Uni Rock, mostly because Dark Wolf's had some computer issues and he's having a hard time. He's actually done some freaking like MacGyver stuff to make his videos and they look great. Even though he's using like tablets and cell phones in tandem to make videos. And he's doing it great because it looks awesome. But we want to get his channel. Oh, dude, I'm giving you my straight opinion. I'm not schmoozing at all. I know I've schmoozed Google and other things. I'm not schmoozing you here. It's the truth. And I want to make sure everybody knows that we're going to be putting these up over there on your place. And if they can go ahead and just jump over and give you a little bit of traffic, that'll help out a lot. So
I would really appreciate it, guys. Dark Wolf's Den. That's where you can find it. And all my theory series videos, that's what I've mainly done to this point, is the Mandela Effect theory series. And we've got all kind of ideas in there. So if you're interested in what could or could not be causing the Mandela Effect, or if you have your own ideas, please check out the channel. And if you want to see these live streams with Uni and Dark Wolf, definitely check out the channel.
Yes, very true. Marlena's asking some questions. Third Phase is making some really good statements in there. So is UFO Underground. They're in here. He's got a great channel. You always want to check out also, our visitors have great channels too. UFO Underground, excellent stuff. Third Phase of Moon, they've been doing really good stuff lately. And if I don't think I've ever said anything bad about Third Phase on my channel. I know I have. Sometimes I might say that I didn't like a certain video for a certain reason. I just want Third Phase to know that if I did, I apologize. And I always speak my mind so hardcore. Sometimes it seems like I might be putting someone down, and I never intentionally meant to do that. And we want you to check out Third Phase. We want you to check out UFO Underground. Anyone that has a channel in here, check them out, because these guys are smart. They're fighting the good fight, and that's what's important. Okay.
Absolutely. Now, let me go ahead and mark down UFO Undergrounds, because I do visit Third Phase. I think I'm subscribed to them, if I'm not mistaken. Uh-huh. A lot of their content. So, like you said, I appreciate them coming in and hanging out with us.
Oh yeah, and write down UFO Underground too, man. He's he was nice enough to let me use a UFO sighting of his on my channel. I recommend
awesome.
I recommend Third Phase go check out UFO Underground too, because he's got the oh my gosh, man. I don't want to pull it up. He's in here. If UFO Underground, if you're still in here, please let me know if I can show a video from your channel. I'm going to ask him really quick. I'd like to show the UFO video that I used on your channel in a little bit. If that's okay, let me know. If not, it's okay. If you want to say no, I won't get mad at you. I understand, but let me type this. UFO Underground, if I can show a vid from your channel, let me know. And I want everyone to see UFO Underground. Third Phase already watches UFO Underground. Okay, good. I'm not trying to plug anyone to be, I'm not trying to say things just to get, I don't recommend channels that I wouldn't watch. Okay.
Right.
And I would watch all of these guys, because, they'll give you the straight up, thing. They'll give you the straight story. Now, hold on. We got to get back on topic, though, because we have to solve at least one of these questions. I'd say 50%. The other two aren't even at fit. Do you think they're at 50% yet solved?
Well, the first one, I'm pretty confident in that we're seeing stars, you know, above us, no matter which side of the sun we're on, we can still see the same ones at certain points. So I'm pretty confident in that answer myself.
Make sure you leave the possibility that something else could be there. That make sure we keep that up there. I know
question
you are.
Everything. Absolutely. Question okay. Everything.
Until you know. and then question it again. That's what I would say. Just be safe.
If science didn't question itself, you and I discussed this, I think, briefly, if not in the last chat, last night we did, I think. Mm-hmm. You know, science, if it would have stuck with what it originally thought, we would still believe certain things that have been proved different back and forth since then. I'm not going to suggest what those things may be.
All right.
But science has grown over the years, and if we didn't question what we thought we already knew, we'd have never learned anything else.
That's right. Well, and you know what? When I brought up the five questions, I'm only following the scientific method, which we don't follow a certain person's scientific method, but we like to propose a hypothesis from a question, or propose just a straight out question. I know a hypothesis is the same thing as a question. It's just a matter of perspective. So we're just going to say we propose something, then we try to come up with educated guesses. That is what the definition of hypothesis. Then we go back after we've answered those, and we try to fit it in our equation and get the, at the end, where the equal sign is, we want it to say truth at the end, or we want it to say real or reality. And that's just what we're trying to do today. And our viewers need us to do this on certain topics. It's good that we're doing this, man. Okay. Now back to the picture before I keep talking for another hour. You know what I'm saying? I talk a lot.
Theory, research, debate. That's what's on the go to my channel, and that is basically what we're about. We theorize, we research it, then we discuss it, and see if we can't come to a common ground on it.
Dude, you always get it right on the freaking nail it right on the head. Okay. geostationary Earth orbit. Now, this is showing us the Earth. It's showing us, it's at the top of this diagram, it shows us 20 hours. What that means is when you're up there, you have to fly at a certain speed not to crash down onto the Earth. I could be wrong. If you fly too slow, you fall down to the Earth. If you fly too fast, you fly away from the Earth. In order to stay in that exact orbit, the key is to fly the speed that it's saying. 1,100 kilometers an hour is 20 hours to circle the Earth at that altitude. So we all understand that well enough, okay? Now, it's saying, look at where the ISS is. It almost looks like it's on the face of the Earth because it's right above. You see? I think we may have just answered our question, man. Are you with me, Dark Wolf? Oh, no. Oh, you back, buddy?
Sorry about that. We had a little dropout here.
That's okay, man. That happens when you're live. Dark Wolf may drop out. He will come back every time. It's just if he has an internet hiccup. So when you were gone, what I said was at the top of this graph is 20 hours, and at the bottom is 11,000 kilometers. If you go faster than 11,000 at that altitude, you will go away from the Earth. So if you go faster, you'll fly out like a line. If you go slower, gravity's going to pull you down and make you crash. That's why you have to have a speed, an altitude, and how long it takes you to circle the Earth when you are talking about orbit. Now that we know those three factors make up orbit, we may have just figured out our problem, okay?
Okay.
Now, I'm going to do a screen draw. So I'm not going to see anything while I'm drawing. Everything's still going to work fine because I'm not going to draw like I was. I'm going to draw on top of this picture because it's going to be important to show what I think is going to make our answer for this thing. So here we go. Now, right here is the ISS. Tell me if you see bright green come up right down here in the middle. Okay.
I see it.
Bright green. Now, that's where the ISS is. It almost looks like it's touching the Earth, correct?
Okay. Correct.
That's all I needed you to see. It was that much. Now let's go over to the sketch pad so I can. I'm not joking. I'm serious. I know I'm being silly. Okay. Sorry.
I love it. That's what makes it fun.
Right. Okay. So what I just drew that green spot on was right here, right? Okay.
Right.
Now, I think maybe we're just too close to the Earth for our perspective to see these satellites. This is only a hypothesis. This is just number one. Or number one was NASA's explanation. This is number two. Maybe we're just so close to the Earth when we look out. Well, you know what? Let's go to the NASA live feed. What do you think about what I just said while I pull up the NASA live feed?
So on Cora, if you continue to read down, it does say that if they are that far out, and if you stare at one spot for long enough, you'll eventually see it. But that they're so far out of our field of view that they're just pretty much impossible with the ISS moving at that consistent speed.
Okay, let me say something though. Guys, I still see your comments. I'm going to read your comments in a second and answer you. I'm not ignoring you. I'm new at this, and if I miss anything, I'm sorry. You can always email me. I'll drop it in. I'll get back to anything you say. I never want to ignore anybody. I don't care if we get 100,000 subs. I swear we're still going to respond to every single thing. Okay,
absolutely.
We were going for NASA live feed. I need to show you this, I think, in order to tell you what I think is the answer here. We're probably going to get like a million copyright hits from this. You know what I mean?
I don't doubt it.
Whoa, dude! Look! It showed the freaking astronaut, man.
Oh wow.
You know, that's kind of rare. Remember last night? We only saw him like twice in like 3 hours. It's loading right now, guys. I'm sorry. All right. I should look this way because my screen's over there. That way it looks like I'm looking over here. That's weird. I'm like, oh, yep, no, I can see stuff. Okay. Now, oh, this is a perfect. Okay, I'm gonna freeze the screen one more time, guys. I promise you that I'm doing it for a good reason. Now here's the I think I might have disproved our guess, man. Or my guess.
Third phase said NASA footage is public fair use.
Good. Dude, third phase. I'm so glad they're watching, man. This is the coolest thing ever. All right. Thank you, third phase. We love you guys. Now, If a satellite, you see my green dot, or is it too small?
I see the green dot. You might want to make it bigger just for our audience.
Okay. Now, it there really, I would need this green dot to be really small, but I just want you to see it. I'm making it big just to see it. But let's say in the middle of this green dot is a satellite way over there. I don't think we would see this satellite because the sun is so bright. And if it, any reflections came off of it, we would probably not see the reflection with the sun behind it. Correct? Would that be correct, you think?
That would be correct. Absolutely. You got the sun basically whiting out our field of view.
Okay. Now, here's the problem, though. I thought we'd answer this, and this happens all the time. We answer something, and it never pans out. But let's say we are on the side. Let's say the sun's behind us, right? And that happens a lot in NASA live feeds. We should see some reflections off of satellites, shouldn't we?
Okay, so yes, I believe we should, because that's still a lot of light coming out and there's not a whole lot to stop it. However, if they are far enough away, 100 miles compared to however many miles 38,000 kilometers is, that might be a viable reason why we can only see so far even in the dark.
You are so right, man. You know what? I almost said to myself, now see, remember when we first started watching the NASA live feed yesterday, it looked like our camera was very close to the Earth. Remember that?
Yes, and then it rose up.
Yes. Now, if it was close to the Earth right now, I would probably write this question off and say we solved it. We're too close to the Earth. We're not getting a good field of view. The atmosphere is in the way. There could be some type of coronal effect that we can't see. There could, you know, there's just a million scientific explanations when you're right
variables,
above the Earth.
Yes.
Thank you. Now, I don't think as high as they are right now, there should be no excuse why we don't see some satellites. Do you agree or not?
I have to disagree with this one because, again, 100 miles and, say, 38,000 is about twice miles, so that's still about 15,000 miles.
All right.
I'd even say about 18,000 miles, give or take.
All right. And that's a good guess. It's a good. Okay, so this last – so what we're going to do – we're going to go ahead and take the three questions we had. We're going to say we got some work done. I think we at least went to 25% on each of them in the quest to answer them. Maybe even more, 50, maybe even more. So that's good work for one session on questions, I think. Yeah, Disintegral's right. There's Disintegral. We were just talking about him, asking where he was. He's in now.
We've seen him a couple times.
Yeah, it's okay. He's on a different time zone than us. So,
to third phase, the only answer I have to the question he just put in chat about, but what about stars? We see them and they tell us they're millions of light years away. This is a fair point, but I would say there's a whole lot more light coming out of these stars than would be reflecting off of a satellite. Would you agree with that?
I do. I completely agree with you. I think we're on the same page on all of this right here.
I wanted to cover that because that was intriguing. That is a fair point. We do see stars that are millions of miles away, but they're quite bigger than a satellite, and they wouldn't be they would be sending a lot more light than reflecting off of a satellite. That'd be my opinion.
Well, you know, I want to give our viewers at least – I strive to give them one on the hard questions. I strive to answer one every day or two because some questions – sometimes you don't get any easy questions. You know what I mean?
Right.
But we did some good work.
They're not easy questions are the ones I enjoy. That's when we learn something.
And that's so true, man. We'd be sitting around fiddling our thumbs if we didn't have emails. Because we get a lot of good emails. I hope UFO Underground's cool. I'm just showing his channel because there's a video on here. And I think it's phenomenal. It blows my mind every time I watch it. If I can find it, I'll pull it up. And we'll look at it while we talk about maybe like a couple other topics. Are you running out of time? How are you on time right now, buddy? I want you to make sure
I'm great on time, Bubba. Okay. I'm great on time.
Well, you know what this session is? This session is us hanging out, doing some research, talking about some topics, figuring some things out. So I want to keep on hanging out if that's cool. So let's do it.
Oh, absolutely. And we got our English team member here now, Disintegral.
All right, man. Well, I hope
we were just talking about our British team earlier.
No, we we'll get a hold of him when we do this tomorrow or the next day. We'll get him in here for a little bit. Maybe at the end of this one, we can send him the link if he's still around. Maybe he'll jump in and we get done here.
Oh, heck yeah, that'd be cool.
Okay, we'll figure it out, though, because I want to make sure we hit some topics, and then we'll figure out bringing people in and not. So, okay, let me widen the screen. All right, we got a good view. This one blows my freak. I always have it muted because I don't want to – we'll mess with sounds later in our live broadcasting, maybe in a few days. We'll test sounds together, and then we'll try to bring them in.
Well, you know, that's something else you can get away with on the copyright is you can play stuff, and I think it's like up to 30 seconds to some stuff as long as you talk over it.
Okay. Well, we'll figure that out. Look at this sighting, though. This sighting
now
is
scary. That is incredible. Even if we say – now, I'm going to go skeptic for a minute. Just because that's what we like to do. Mm-hmm. So even if we say this is a cloud formation and it's shining through the clouds, that's still a really, really odd chance of that type of cloud. What in the world was that?
Yeah, this is it, dude. You got to watch right here, man.
Okay, I stand corrected on everything I just said.
It just attached. Now look at what happens. They zoomed in, so they didn't come apart. Now, okay. So, yeah, let's go back because let's talk about that real quick.
Yeah.
Okay. Look at this. Look at this thing. I've actually used this in Photoshop and tried to examine it a little bit to, you know, see what I could find. Because right. When I was watching it, until I saw this, I was like, this is interesting. When I saw this, I was like mind blown, like straight out. Bam. It got me. And you get a feeling in your stomach sometimes when you watch UFO videos. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
You get this feeling in the pit of your stomach. This one, oh, dude. It gave me chills.
Kind of like,
man,
the goosebumps when you hear a real ghost story. I know exactly what you mean.
Or when you first, like, you know, when you first hear a Mandela effect, when you've Mandela effect for a year, and then you finally hear one, and you're like, wait a minute. And just like Alien Addict said, Chewie was supposed to get that medal. You know, he got that medal where I'm from, you know.
Right. I don't particularly remember because I watched that particular one like when I was a child and maybe a couple years later, so I haven't freshened up on it. So I don't really remember that particular one. Most of them I do.
So yeah, okay. So what I'm going to do is we'll look at a couple of these UFO. I've got a UFO I want to show you in a little bit. I want us to talk about a couple little things that are going on around.
Before you do that real quick, for everybody that is in the chat and that doesn't know, yes, my channel is about Mandela effect theory, but I've actually studied conspiracy theory since I was 12 years old, whether it be UFOs, paranormal, I say conspiracy theory, let me rephrase that. I've studied the paranormal since I was 12 years old. I started out with UFOs, as a matter of fact. Ufology is one of my favorite studies. And then the cryptids.
Yeah, there you go.
I can't
it's
remember
hard to
the
get out sometimes.
Cryptozoology.
There you go. I couldn't remember it either.
I knew it had zoo somewhere in there. Mm-hmm. But anyway, I've studied this stuff for many, many, many years. So though I'm known as the Mandela Effect channel and Mandela Effect person, I'm all about the conspiracies and the paranormal altogether. Because what I wanted to do, and I tried to do with my channel, is tie paranormal into real science. Because paranormal is anything we haven't found a way to explain yet.
Yeah. Oh, for sure. And that's the thing. That's why when I made my channel, I was a UFO guy. And I said to myself, you know, I want to bring UFOs to the public. I want to do some conspiracies. I just want to get on YouTube and meet people and talk and have fun. But once I got going, it's gone this way. It's gone into problems with time, and it's gone into UFO phenomenon. Because I think the other conspiracies are great. It's just the last week or two, this is where it's been. And it could just be a fad or a trend, but whatever it is, I think it's this way because there's something significant going on with those two topics.
Especially when you get the time. Time is another one that just, I love it so much. Time travel, movies, theories, ideas, that's one of my big obsessions. And it hurts my head to think about sometimes because the paradoxes are amazing.
Oh, but so true, man.
Mentioned something earlier. You were going to update us on some stuff like Dr. Lupo?
Oh, Well, no, I was just going to say Dr. Lupo's got a lot of good guests scheduled in the next couple weeks. Dr. Taryn P. Lupo, it's a channel on YouTube if anybody hasn't been there that sees this. He's going to have a lot of cool guys talking soon. You know what, man? Oh, gosh. I'm going to send Third Phase a message after this. I'm going to send Dr. Lupo a message. We've been talking about, Dr. Lupo and I have been talking about, you know, we need do we need to talk to new people? And I think the live community on YouTube really needs, I know Third Phase does a great radio show, and maybe we could just all talk sometime. It doesn't have to be on air, but I just think we maybe all should talk sometime. So I'm just going to message people after this. That's all I'm trying to say. But Dr.
Absolutely.
And this is what I'm going to do for us. Me and you talked. I wanted to bring up, me and you talked about having channel guests, you know, and when somebody has a channel, and we're going to reach out to them and we're going to find guests, because Dr. Lupo does his round table. I want to do a more direct interview. I'd like you to be there when you're available for him. And
right, absolutely.
You know, we'll do a couple. We'll do some interviews in this too. I'd like this show to be hang out with us, solve problems, watch some good, cool stuff, and then I'd like, you know, when we can get a guest, I'd like it to be let's ask them some cool stuff about. And I don't want to do. I know some interviews can go into the realm of, you know, just they ask any question they want. I'm going to make sure I have a thing we follow. I want it to always be super positive, happy hangout. I want it to be one of those cool, hey, you're a cool guy, come hang out, and we're just going to talk for a little bit and jump away. You know what I'm saying? No, no friction topics, no topics that could cause friction. If there is friction somewhere, it's not coming onto this channel, so that's what I want to make sure we do.
I absolutely 110% agree with everything you just said. I think we should have some channel guests and interview style. And like you said, I like that. Keeping it positive, a specific interview. Not that we're going to lead an interview by any means. I don't like when somebody leads an interview and tries to lead to certain information. Like, we're going to be very we're going to be very open with the questions, but very positive centered, I guess you'd say. We're not going to try not to go down the dark roads, but we must always remember, Uni, and this is something I say a lot. Just because we don't focus on it doesn't mean we can't acknowledge it.
There we go. We will. We will acknowledge things as they come up. We're just going to make sure that we Dr. Lupo taught me something in the last week. And at first, I wanted to say, Doc, why are you like this? He taught me that you should that negativity is not even worth focusing on right now. Anything negative isn't even worth focusing on right now. And I said, Doc, what about if we need to focus on it, you know, to do something? And he said, you know, that could be another. I'm not quoting him now. I'm telling you the impression.
Paraphrasing.
Yeah, because it was a long conversation. It's been mixed up in different times, but what he really has taught me though is that we need to focus on the positive things that are going on, just because that will give the people that come around, they won't have to click on a video when on any of the stuff me, you, him, and some of our other like team members do.
Right.
They won't worry about clicking on it and then being hit in the face with any negative stuff. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
That's
if the they know that they trust our channels to be positive and have that positive outlook and can come away from our videos with at least a sense of positivity, if not a centered sense, but without a negative feeling to it.
Thank you. Yes. And that, and when he said, now he said, if we need to get hard on, like hard on, I'm sounding sexual. If we need
nice.
To get hard on, oh, hey, if we need to get tough on some, really, if on a topic that could be touchy or could make somebody, anybody, the interviewer or even the interviewee feel uncomfortable, we're going to make sure that we do that one in private. What Dr. Lupo's saying is, you know, like if we have to go to CERN and kill a bunch of interdimensional aliens someday, they're not going to broadcast that on YouTube. We're not going to have like, you know, space flight 1000, you know what I'm saying? So I'm just saying, or if we need to argue with somebody, we'll keep that private. You know, there's not going to be any ambush style upsetting stuff that happens is all I'm
no
trying
fear
to say.
I like what Dizzy said here. Yes, too many channels rely on fear porn for views, and it leaves viewers scared and anxious.
And I don't hate on them. I don't hate on channels that may touch on scary or other types of topics. I think it's necessary. Now, I go on YouTube many times to look for things that can leave you feeling that way, because you need to see that sometimes. When you're prepared to see it, you need to be able to go see that. You know, right. If you're researching the Illuminati, you're going to see a lot of stuff that is upsetting. If you're researching, just any topic that could war, if you're looking at news, you're going to see a lot of topics that are upsetting. But we're just going to keep that out of here at least for a while. And we'll make sure we tell people if we ever say, okay, you know, aliens, they exposed disclosure last week, and we need to talk about what aliens could do. They could blow us up. So if we need to hit topics like that, we'll just go ahead and disclaimer it later on. For the next couple weeks, for the show we're doing, we're going to keep everything just happy. Okay, I went too long on that, but that's okay, because it's good to go too long if you're talking about being happy. So what we're doing
absolutely. Now. And speaking of being happy, I am happy that Marlena from the chat has actually dropped our link over in Discord, so we can get some people from over there coming on over and checking us out. Everybody that does check us out. And if I may put a plug real quick, Uni. Uni and I have agreed that we are live streaming from his channel. However, this will not be available after the stream on his channel. This will be available on Dark Wolf's Den for those who have not been in here when we said this earlier. Mm-hmm. So if you want to go back and watch any of this, show your friends, want to tell your friends where to find it, it will be on Dark Wolf's Den. Pretty soon after we get done here, we'll have it up there. I can't promise you how long. How technical difficulties are.
It'll take a while. Uploading takes a while. But I do want to also make sure, because Dr. Lupo did teach me this too. Make sure if you do like anything, not just any stuff you're watching now, anything you see on YouTube, give it a like. Give them a sub if they're good people. Now, here's the other key thing. I'm not saying you guys don't. I don't share enough. I'm going to start sharing videos I like more often, just because I want to share videos of good people. That's what it is. I want to get it out there. Now, let's move on to the topic, and we'll get another space in there to talk about other things too. But okay, so we opened up a news aggregator just now, because part of our show, we're going to look at the news, but we're going to look at it on our topics. We're not just going to go into the general news and look at that. Too often we are surrounded by lies and crap. And I know we're going to see a lot of lies and crap when we search UFO news, Mandela effect news. But we're just going to look at some topical news and just talk about it for a minute. If that
sounds great. That sounds great.
Now, we've got a low-flying cylinder UFO reported over California on MUFON, and there's no date. So let's see when this happened.
I would like to see that, because the cigar shapes have been gone for quite a while. That's the first one I've seen in a couple years.
It's been there have been some, but it's been mostly triangle and orbs lately. I know Third Face can give us a good update on that.
March 16th, 2017, right here in the... Yep. About halfway down the page, it listed in the article.
Okay, so let's look. That's a good picture. I would think cloud at first, but it just seems
too solid.
I can't make that judgment from this one. So we'll say that's a good art. That's a good little article. I like that.
I don't see any wings to suggest it's a plane of any type.
No. Now we've got top 10 festivals for UFOs and alien lovers.
I got to hear about these.
How cool would it be to find a? Now listen to this. How cool would it be to find a festival where, like, even just if we could get like even a few people that we talk to online on YouTube, people that create and viewers, to find one of these festivals, and then find one where the one that more people could, the most people could go to, and then we all go hang out for a day at a festival. Wouldn't that be awesome?
Oh, that would be incredible, man. Right. Yeah, they're a little bit behind the times, aren't they?
Yeah, if they're going to do this stuff, they might as well help us out, you know?
Absolutely. Yeah. At least release a bare basic version anyway.
Thank you. Now, let's go ahead and look here. There's a festival in Roswell. I think these are yearly or they wouldn't be festivals.
UFO I know festival. Roswell is. I know a guy that goes there.
Yeah. New Hampshire. Now, if I'm not mistaken, I know a couple people in Dr. Lupo's group are from New Hampshire. That's cool.
I think he's from around that area too. Around that area.
I thought he was. I was going to say that, but then I didn't want to question myself.
Right.
Because I thought I might be wrong. So Marlena probably knows. Marlena, if you know if Dr. Lupo's near New Hampshire, let us know that so we can tell him about this sometime. Okay. You know what? Oh my gosh, dude! I just had the freaking perfect idea. If we can find one creator or viewer that lives close to just one of these festivals, we could get someone to get footage from it.
That's what I thought you were headed to begin with. Yeah, that would be great too. Just walking around and looking at the booths and just seeing what they got to offer, seeing what it's about and what it's like. I think that'd be amazing.
Interview 10 people, ask them what their experience is. That would be cool, man.
And for the viewers that don't want to be up on camera, that's fine. You want to send it to us or somehow, just interview them and get their side, send it to us. We'll gladly put it up for you.
And then we have things like Google Drives now, which are like the coolest. The cloud is cool, even though there's a lot of conspiracy around the clouds. Not the cloud clouds, the computer clouds. I mean, we just saw some crazy clouds a little bit ago. But, yeah, even though, we can always drop any video you guys take into a Google Drive and put it right on our computer. And that's what's beautiful about technology these days. We're connected in ways we never have been in the past. Here's the Alien Encounter Festival in Texas. I bet Alien Addict's close to this one because he mentioned Manchester before when I talked to him. I bet I could get him to go there.
I wonder where Disintegral is. He's over there too. He might be able to go to one or two and give us some feedback. Part this of the team. Is,
yeah, dude. Yes. Okay, we got one in Oregon, Nova Scotia. And there's another in Texas. We need to get a hold of some Texas people. They could probably hit two of them in one season.
Right.
Really good footage. Pine Brush, New York. I was hoping one would be from Hawaii because I know that's where Third Phase is from. I'd love to see them go to a UFO festival, man.
Oh, wouldn't that be great?
That'd be freaking awesome. Well, okay, let's get out of this article. We want to always make sure we keep ourselves moving. If I ever go too long, you let me know. I'll do the same for you, okay? I'll never get mad at you for it. Never going to get mad at each other for any suggestion each other makes. So,
but I like that idea of sending out a viewer or even a video maker if you can and go out and try to get us some footage or even trying to be able to meet at one of these festivals sometime. That would be great.
Dude, Third Phase just commented, like, the most awesome fucking idea. They should do a Third Phase festival. That would,
they wouldn't have a place big enough to put it.
Oh, dude, I'd go. No, seriously. Yeah, man. We could get we need to talk about this later. I'm writing this down just because I want to make sure I keep – if this ever does happen, we're going to make sure we have at least footage. That's going to be the
bare minimum.
And if I can arrange like a family vacation around that time, that would be awesome.
And where are we going?
I won't even tell him. Dude, my family would be excited. My son would love it. Dude. He watches Third Phase all the time. He would. He watches Dr. Lupo now, and he watches every channel that we talk about. He would love it, man. My son.
Oh, that's excellent.
He'd be ready in a second. He would film for us. Now, this is the thing. We all have cameras that, and I'll tell you right now, a lot of people think their cell phone camera isn't good enough to get footage for a channel. It is because we can shrink it. You can make footage, into a smaller square, and it still makes it look good. And we've got filters that will make you cell phone footage look a little better. So,
I'll be honest, my cell phone camera is better than the one on my tablet.
Oh, we got to read this one, dude. Oh no, my cell phone camera is better than the one in my camera because I got a cheap camera and my cell phone was a real expensive cell phone, which I think is crazy. I record with my cell phone sometimes because of that.
Well, here's the funny thing. My cell phone was $45.
And it still has a good camera, right?
I mean, and it's got a better camera than the tablet does. I mean, it's crazy. Those who think your cell phone ain't got a good camera, I promise. The cheap ones have a great camera on them. The backside camera, not the front. The one that facing away from you, that's a great camera. All right, Russian homeless man makes something UFO responds with imaginary gun.
Yes. I was just sending third phase my email. I just want to make sure they can get a hold of me anytime they have time. Yeah, I saw this and I said, we've got to talk about this one. Alien kidnapping, Russian homeless man. Yes. Now, it said he mistaked the drone, or he may have. I went down. I'm starting to get lag. Oh, an imaginary gun. Oh, look at that. Oh, dude, that's funny. I'd like to shake his imaginary gun holding hand, man. He's just fun. That's a funny dude, man. Imagine if
that's awesome.
What do you think he thought? You know, he saw like a drone fly by and he's like, oh shit, it's a UFO. And he's like, pew, 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 pew. You know what I'm saying?
In his hand, he had a laser rifle.
Thank you. I can get down, man. I'd love to freaking, this guy's, he's probably cool to party with.
Oh, I bet.
Do something like that.
Just, could you imagine, though, seeing him walking around just shooting the air with his fake laser? That'd be awesome.
Yeah. Listen to what it says. Whatever the case, the clip could only further strengthen the conviction that humanity is neither ready to make contact with extraterrestrials or submit to our robotic overlords.
Wow. Don't you love the spin the media puts on those things?
They spin it like a top, dude. They spin it like the earth on a... spinning on its axis.
Man, I tell you what. Yeah, the public's not ready because we said they're not ready. I think if they come down, people would be like, oh, huh.
Oh. Listen. Here's an interesting one. I've seen a lot of whoa. Now, this is just, you know, some of the ads that come up. I don't know why they – look how many ads are in this. This is crazy. Oh. Now I'm getting this article is giving me some problems, so we're getting out of it. It's giving me some crazy, crazy bad ads.
Yeah, that's not good. Oh, yeah. That's garbage.
Hey, Marlena said thanks for us having a show tonight, and I just want to let Marlena and everybody else know, me and Dark Wolf are going to hang out and do our normal talk that we try to have every night. We're just going to do it like this because me and Dark Wolf do this. We get together and talk like this. So we're going to do it. Now, sometimes we might not do it real long, but we're going to make sure, and I'm going to tell you this too, we're going to attempt in the future to do it at the same time every night. Now, I can't promise that, but we're just going to try.
No, my work schedule is kind of nutty, and it's coming on peak season, so the hours probably will vary when I get in.
After this peak season, you know?
Yes. This week's looking pretty good as far as early outs, but, you know, again, we'll see. I say that, and I could be there to 3:30 tomorrow, so.
I don't got anything going on the next couple days. I'm just chilling. Everybody sleeps during the day around here, so I got the run of the studio at night. Okay. Proof alien UFO cover-up. NASA accused of deleting Earth-orbiting UFO from the Apollo mission space photo. Now, this, I bet Third Phase of the Moon has lots of opinions on this. They've done a lot of shows that have to do with this type of topic before. And, you know, there have been some really – now, we talked about this with Alien Addict the other day, and this is really crazy because they've just had so many instances where they've deleted stuff out of pictures. So we need to – that's, you know what? We just did it. We went into our news thing. We found a topic to hit on for a few seconds because – you know, what is worse than one of the top agencies in the world, in their field, manipulating evidence? I don't think there's much worse than that.
Oh, that's as bad as you can get.
What could they be deleting? I know we know. We already know they're deleting UFOs. But I mean, what could NASA say they're deleting?
What could instead? They legitimately try to say they're deleting?
That's the question.
So the only reason that I can think of just spur top of my head, you know, spur of the moment, would be blurry images. They're just bad images we wanted to get rid of. Things that just look like something it wasn't.
Yes, that could be something they say. I'll say that number two, we always want to do 3 to 5. We're going to go 3 here. So number two, they're going to say that it's blurry. They wanted to clean it up. There was a bad thing. They are a flare, and they rubbed it. They just took it out, okay? I'd say number two is it's along the same lines. Maybe they could claim there was damage to the picture or to the camera.
Okay. Okay.
Maybe that could. I know that's probably too close, but that's far. That's where I could go.
Well, no, hopefully. Not necessarily, because a blurry image could just be a movement opposed to damage to the camera.
You know, Third Phase made a good point. The tabloids in the UK, they don't like sharing Third Phase footage. And here's the messed up part. They do share other channels' footage, okay?
Huh.
Now here's the weird part of this. Now we just saw, now I didn't bring it up because I didn't see multiple instances of it, but I saw a video, and only because it came into one of my searches, I clicked on a video that was from a major, not Third Phase, but a major UFO channel, and they had it in many tabloids. And I'm saying there's probably like 10 news stories right off the cusp of this sighting.
Right.
I'm going to say something interesting right as soon as I tell you this next part, though. Okay. So the tabloids put out a bunch of stories. It's a YouTuber's thing. The YouTuber claims that he talked to a Facebook guy, puts it on, and then the tabloiders get it. They put it out. It's a big circle. Tabloids push them to YouTube. YouTube pushes it to the tabloids. It goes back and forth. But when I clicked on the story, and I'll find it real quick because it's really relevant. Now it's relevant. When I clicked on the story, there was a copyright on the picture to the man, and it said his name, and then it said Facebook and had a copyright.
What?
Yeah. I just found that strange as hell, man.
I thought you didn't have the ability to copyright on things like Facebook. I thought it was public use when it hits Facebook.
Yeah, exactly. Just like with YouTube. That's how some people get away with copying someone else's content without anything. Look right here. Oh, no, shit. I might have misspoke, dude. I swear I saw one where it did that, but look right here. So at the bottom, right here, it says, amazing crystal clear footage of these UFOs. And look at the bottom. Mauricio Morales. It says copyright the man's name. It didn't say Facebook. So he copyrighted it himself. But he did put it in a Facebook post, published it. That's where this was found. So what you just said is relevant. How can he put it on a social platform and share it to the world and say, there you are, and then copyright the image, right?
Right.
Now, if he copyrighted it.
Yeah, that don't make a lot of sense.
So you know what I think? I think he copyrighted it first.
And then made it into something else?
Maybe he copyrighted this image, this thing.
Uh-huh.
Then shared it. That would be the only thing that would make sense for the reason why the copyright's there, legally at least. Or am I wrong?
No, that's legal, legit. Yeah. If you put anything with copyright on there, you've automatically got your copyright.
Third Phase made two good points. I'm going to say their last point first. It was really good on this. He said Facebook is a really good place. They said Facebook is a really good place for thieves trying to claim videos as their own, which is true. And he said the UK media monopoly. That is very true.
Because Rupert Murdoch pretty much owns the UK media monopoly.
Exactly. Exactly. There's an owner. It's one thing. They have, instead of having one major tabloid, they've got 100 of them. But they all follow the same formula because it's all a monopoly. This is actually proven somewhere. You can actually read this.
Well, he got in trouble a couple years back over the Daily Mail and another newspaper together, and how one was for one group and one was for another.
Exactly.
And I'm not sure what he pulled that into, but he got in a lot of trouble for that. And he was looked at real hard on that.
You're right there, man. Right on the money with it, man. Oh yeah, Disintegral's got some good stuff. Murdoch owns a lot of the media.
Murdoch has a direct access pass to the Queen at any time he wants. Open meeting.
You said that at the same time that Disintegral did, but he said the Prime Minister. But you're both saying, you know. Well, I mean, probably both. You're probably both right. You see what I'm saying?
I got the information from Disintegral, so I must be fair with that.
Okay. We give credit where credit's due around here.
Absolutely.
And that's why we are going to say, if you're going to drink an energy drink, you want to drink Red Bull, our sponsor. I had to throw that in there. Sorry. Red Bull's going to freaking flip on me one day because I call Monster Red Bull all the time. Like 6 of my videos I call Monster Red Bulls just to poke fun. I'm going to get sued one day. Nah, they can't do nothing to me.
Okay, so Dizzy's out, right? Dizzy said that it is the Prime Minister, not so much the Queen. She's a tough one to get an audience with, even for Rupert.
You know, he would. Disintegral's our dude in the UK. He'd know too. Him and Alien Addict, they're our team members over in the UK. They know this stuff. And it's cool. You got to really talk to who lives in a country in order to get the correct information about their government, because everything we hear about their government is going to be filtered through media and our government. You know what I mean?
Right. But we actually got somebody over there where we can get the real truth from the ground, not the government political answer from the media.
Yeah. The Bitter Truth added a good point. He said, hashtag cucumber. And that's where we're going to leave off on this story. Hashtag cucumber. You know, when we
okay, get, now I'm confused. What is hashtag cucumber? I don't understand this one.
It's just a joke. It's just a joke that everybody does. It's just a random thing they like putting in. So what
we'll do is a new one to me. I've never seen that one.
So what we'll do is at the end of a story where we hit some type of really government-y type topic, we'll just hashtag cucumber that and back
sounds
out.
Great.
I don't know what it means. I don't care what it means. Don't tell me what it means. We're gonna hashtag cucumber this shit. So.
Yeah, that's probably something we don't want to know what it means, huh?
I choked on my e-cig. That was a good one. Yeah,
ladies,
that was a good one.
Dark Wolf choked up Uni. There we go.
Hey, you'll see that happen a lot on this channel. It's okay. All right. Now, we said we were going to type in UFO into the news aggregator. We got some really good stuff out of it. Let's go ahead and we'll jump to let's go to Illuminati just for the hell of it. Is that cool with you just for a minute?
Oh, I love discussing these guys. I think they're absolutely hilarious. The Illuminati is a group that has gotten so in our face that they've almost gotten so arrogant we can't help but just sit back and go, wow, really?
Yeah. Now listen to this one. You want to hear something crazy? And I'm glad Disintegral's over here. The bizarre conspiracy theory claims that the Beatles were created by the Illuminati to encourage U.S. kids to take drugs.
What?
I am a conspiracy guy. Okay, what I mean by that is when I'm growing up, if I hear the word conspiracy, I'm reading that shit. And I've never heard that one, though. Have you heard that?
I've never heard that. That is brand new to me, Bubba.
Yeah, dude. Hey, we learned something today.
If you don't learn something every day, ladies and gentlemen, your day's been wasted. Personally, I might learn something I've forgotten a couple of few times, but I learned it again.
You know what? We know what we're going to do. We're going to have Dark Wolf's life quotes, and we're going to put them into hashtags. That's a good one. If you don't learn something that day, then you wasted your day. That's a great freaking quote, man.
Appreciate that.
That should be the title of one of our, like, that should be at least in the about section when you put that on the page. Seriously. I don't know if you can make a hashtag that long, though. What's the requirements on how long a hashtag is?
I'm not sure there are some, because I've seen some a mile long.
Okay. Well, shit. We'll just put all that sentence into a hashtag. That's a good one. Yeah. The Beatles, though, you know, trying to get kids to take drugs, really? Any grounds there?
Okay, so you're talking about an era where it didn't take nothing to get the kids to take drugs. They were doing it because of anti-war and protest and you name it. You're talking about an era where drugs was like candy to us today. You know, I don't think the Beatles were the big influence, if you will. I think they were one of many influences. As far as them being created, no, I'm sorry. They started in England. Number one, I'd say that England doesn't have Illuminati, but I don't see that happening. They were a bunch of young kids trying to make music.
Mm-hmm.
They started just like the rest of them.
And even if the Illuminati decided to grab a hold of them, they probably would use them for some way more nefarious reasons than just to influence drugs, kids to smoke weed or something, you know?
Okay, you made a good point. It is wonderful Disintegral is in here. The Beatles were straight-laced in the beginning, he said.
Okay. So we know they weren't at least created for it. Now, if we can actually prove that part of a statement is mostly false, then that doesn't mean that the whole statement's false, but it at least gives us an insight. So that really helps with that one, you know?
And for those who said he did LSD, they did not pick that up until it became the big thing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, this next one's going to floor you because it's about Katy Perry's shoes. Did I go into that one okay?
Thanks. No.
Floor and shoes? I don't know. I was trying. Sorry. Okay. I've analyzed Katy Perry's actions many times over, and it seems to me that she brought some of this on herself when she told the Rolling Stones, quote, "If the Illuminati existed, I would like to be invited. I see all that shit, and I'm like, come on, let me in. I want to join the Illuminati." That's that's Katy Perry's quote, buddy.
Reread the quote, please.
I'd like to. If the Illuminati existed, I see all that shit, and I'm like, I'm in. I want to join the Illuminati. I want to be in the club. I'm paraphrasing.
Yeah, I got you. So if you look at her older works, I don't even question that she's been in the club for quite a while. If the club exists, I really believe she's in it because they're supposed to practice dark magic. And I know a lot of people might hate on me for this one. I apologize. But I'm going to say it anyway. Dark Horse. The line to Dark Horse is, so you want to play with magic? Well, it's good to know what you're fighting for. If that doesn't sound like an Illuminati like theme fight song, I don't know what does.
You know what these celebrities do, bro? These celebrities act like they say this to get us looking the wrong way. They want us to think, oh, I'd love to be in the Illuminati. And then like 10 minutes later, they're hopping in a black tinted limousine and driving off to the grotto where they're having, you know, these huge rituals like they have in their videos, in my opinion.
Oh, absolutely. And, you know, a lot of people would, even myself, would have said, oh, well, perhaps it's just a theory. When we learned about spirit cooking and the whole, you know, Hillary Clinton thing, when that all came to light, the general public can't even question this anymore. Like, really? Dark magic? Yeah. Or fakes. They're telling you they're doing it. They're telling you they're doing it. They're not even making two ways about it. They're doing dark rituals.
Dude, you're right. And I've heard a reason for this. It's actually a really good reason for why they have to put it out there right in your face. And it goes with, I heard this on the NASA subject of them lying to us. But now what I heard in this is that, okay, they have to show it. They have to, like, okay, so in the world of karma, if you walk up to someone, like, right behind them, okay, and let's say you punch them right in the back of the head, and then you get in a fight with them, okay, you've got some bad karma, right? You just walked up on somebody and popped them one. Uni Rockinati, that's my new stuff. Dr. Michael said, join the Uni Rockinati. That's us, buddy. That's us. That's the name of our club.
Yeah,
that's right. That's our show. That's our freaking show, dude. The Uni Rockinati. We got to put Dark Wolf in there too. We'll figure that out later. Okay. Oh, okay. So what I was saying was, though, like if you walked up to somebody, though, let's say you heard them talking bad about you, you said, "Look, dude, don't talk bad about me," and then they turn around and punch you, and you fight back. Your karma's not negative there. You were defending yourself. He was being an asshole. Right. All those things are in. So, in order for the Illuminati to do all this evil stuff to people. So they want to do evil stuff to people, but they know if they do it, it really is going to jack their life. It's going to really mess them up on the grand scheme of the wave of, you know, good and evil. So what they do is they just straight tell you. You look at the video and you say, oh, Dark Horse, play with magic. She's riding a really dark black horse and it looks Illuminati. It looks all crazy. She must be in the Illuminati. Then you got 8 billion people saying Katy Perry's not in the Illuminati, you know, because she's just selling us. And so in order for their spells to work, in order for their stuff to be effective, that's the explanation I've heard. It really did sit with me.
There's a name for this. It is called lesser magic. I've actually studied a lot of the rituals that they do. I did not say practice. I said studied for those who are listening. I've studied many religions, including the dark ones, and one thing they have to do in lesser magic in order to make the higher magic work is they have to tell you. Mm. And a lot of them can do it real sly-like, but like you said, they have to put it in your face and tell you. Now, whether you believe it or not, they don't care. That's not the point.
Oh, yeah. Exactly, put it bro.
And if you want to follow the woo for just a minute, if you put anything into the consciousness, and I believe all consciousness is connected, you're going to enact that energy through a variety of consciousnesses and be able to feed back on it later on. That's how the magics work, at least some of them.
Yeah, and that's a theory. And now, like, I want all the viewers to make sure they know, you know, we come up with theories. We try to answer things in a logical way. We keep our mind open for the fantastic explanation, for the magical, for the spiritual explanation. And we're going to keep our mind open and look at it from every viewpoint. And that's what we do. And that summed everything we just did right there up so perfect. I think we went to a good place. I think that whole progression we went from, you know, we searched the Illuminati, we saw a couple of those things, and then we got that really good thing in there where we kind of gave a good reason, you know?
Absolutely. We went full circle.
Thank you. I'm just making sure I'm seeing what you're seeing so we can keep things like that up. You know, we're staying on
track. Definitely on the same page, brother.
Okay, we're moving on, though. We're still inside of our news aggregator, so we're on the part of the show.
I got to say something real quick, and I apologize for interrupting you.
No, go.
It really caught my eye, because for the first time in the news aggregator, I see two words I have not seen besides a Sphere article. I see the words Mandela Effect right there at the top. I've not ever seen this in a news thing.
Now, I've been pulling stories out of this for the Mandela Effect for a while now. Oh, yeah. It's in the
news. So I haven't seen it. I haven't seen a lot of news aggregators.
Now, I searched it. I did search Mandela Effect, but what I want you to see is you do get a lot of news articles that pop up, not just having keywords that say Mandela Effect, but that are written specifically targeted towards the Mandela Effect. I'll show you some.
Now, are we talking targeted smearing? Are we having positive spins on any of it? Or how's the media taking this? I haven't followed this. Like I said, I ain't seen it really out there in the media.
I'm so glad you said that. Now, we have this one, which is fuck. I'm sorry, some saying F-bombs. You know, we don't like. I want our viewers to know right now, and I'm sorry, because this is just a setting that was left over from our previous live stream. If you cuss inside the if you curse inside of our comments, there is a chance. I'm not saying it will happen, but you might get your comment pulled. It's not us. I just want to make sure you guys know we are not filtering you. So please don't think it's us. Okay. Now, this place is fuck combustion. I guess it's a web page. But now it says right here, Mandela Effect. Am I just high? I don't know if you've heard of Mandela Effect, but it's a phenomenon that is being attributed to CERN in the use of the quantum computer, causing alternate dimensions and changing history. And basically, he goes down asking, am I just high or have I lost the plot or what's going on? So it spins this topic from every direction in the media right now.
Well, I like that. You know, for once, I got to say the media is accidentally creating an unbiased arena for this. Because it's taking so many viewpoints.
Let's look at this really quick. Oh, hey, Third Phase of Moon just messaged me. Yeah, they said they might want to say hi. Now we have to do this. So.
Oh, Third Phase, bring them on. They want to join us. Absolutely.
I'm going to mess with some settings. I'm going to try to get them an invite real quick.
You know what? This could be the part of the show where we start bringing on our guests. Also have our British teammate come in.
Okay, yeah, we'll do that here after we finish this part. Yeah, we can get him in here too right after we do the Third Phase thing, and we'll get all this taken care of, yeah. Okay, I got a message. I don't know where it popped up from. I don't know if it was email or Hangouts, so I'm going to look. How about Dark Wolf? You know, while I'm doing this, why don't you do me a favor and tell me you had a couple videos about the Mandela Effect and a couple theories where you talked about the devil part. You said the word, I didn't want to misquote it. It was something about, is the devil responsible or something? And I wanted, later in the show, I was going to ask you that. Can you tell me about that while I try this out?
Okay, absolutely. So the video is called Did the Devil Do It? And what I decided to do, yes, I am a science-based channel, but in the community, I must give everybody a voice. Because another aspect of my channel is to give the entire Mandela Effect community a voice. All the ones who want to bring me their theories, bring them to me. I got something else to tell you on that later, too. But the Did the Devil Do It was a great, great theory. I learned so much. The Christians basically say that Satan is behind it. And the reason they point to this is the Bible changes for one. Only one entity would want to change the Bible, the devil. And that makes sense to a degree. Even if it is humans changing it and a demonic entity behind it, you know, it take your take on that. But we are talking about the Christian belief system. So let's take that under accord. So under their belief, because all these Bible words are changing and it changes the meaning so much in that book. I have to say, I'm even not word impressed. I don't want to use the word impressed, but really amazed. There's the word I need, by some of the changes that are being put in there that really, really truly change the meaning of the Bible. And I was able to link up and learn so much about that video. The fact that we do have a lot of weird things coming together right now. If you look at the Mandela Effect overall, it does speak in the Bible of, and I'm not trying to preach to anybody. I do know a little Bible, but I'm not trying to preach to anybody. Just put that disclaimer out there. We are talking about a Christian-based theory once again.
Yeah, but, for sure.
But if you look at the Mandela Effect overall, and it speaks of the great deception that even the very elect would be deceived if that were possible. What other deception than changing reality itself? How could the very elect not be deceived? That's the only way I think that could be even possible. Matched up with the alignment and, you know, different things, the Christians say it could be pointing to the beginning of the end times or the beginning of the revelation and the 7 years of I'm not even going to finish that because I don't remember what it is. But 7 years of bad stuff, I guess it is. And then leads up to Christ coming back and the apocalypse, basically. So the Christians believe that this is the beginning of the apocalypse. And they've got a lot of interesting evidence to point to make this claim. I got to say.
Oh, okay. I think Disintegral may have suggested that. Third phase, I may have gotten – I thought you might have messaged me through YouTube and it popped up. It may have been one of my viewers messaged me and said that if you do want to come in, that's perfectly awesome. If you guys don't want to, I'm not trying to pressure you. I just had a pop-up that said that. I just want to make sure that that's out there, you know. It could have been one of my viewers if you guys didn't message me and ask that. It could have been one of my viewers that said, hey, ask Third Face to come on. So I just want to let you know there's no pressure here and we can do it now or in a future thing. We'd love to have you tonight or any time, just so you know. You're always welcome on the rock. So, okay. Well, thanks, Dark Wolf. I didn't mean to interrupt you. I just, so here's what happened. When we were talking, I had a pop-up somehow on my screen. I don't know what it was. It could have been Hangouts or it could have been email or it could have been YouTube. But I had a pop-up that said, I saw Third Phase and then I saw would maybe like to join. So I don't know who sent it yet. I don't know if it was a viewer or them, but I just thought, oh, well, if it is them, I'm going to give them the option while we're talking is all I was trying to do. So. You know,
gotcha. So there's no confusion. I gotcha, definitely.
Oh, for sure. I just want to make sure Third Phase doesn't feel pressured if they're busy. You know, I don't want them to have to, you know, sometimes you're not ready to go live, you know, so. But yeah, man.
Him and Disintegral are talking because they sent an email or something and another one said yay. So I think, I don't know. I'm assuming. Just assuming.
Oh, yeah.
So they made.
Hell no.
So, like, private chat.
Oh, here comes Blake.
Okay, I guess I'm live. Hold on a sec. Let me just turn my background sound down, and we don't want to have any echo going down.
Okay, and I think
we're doing it. I think we're doing it.
Excellent. Yeah. Thanks for joining us tonight, buddy.
Yeah, well, definitely.
Okay, I'm going to turn this down. I don't want any feedback. I want it to sound all good. Don't want to destroy your show, but wow, you know, I like what you guys are doing. So far, whole idea, there's all these YouTube channels out there, right? And there's styles of how they go about doing things. And what I like about Unirock and his way of objective thinking on the whole subject matter is quite enlightening because he's getting a lot of reactions. He's not stating, he's an expert or anything. He just wants to get down to the bottom of what is going down. And that's what I think Third Phase of Moon is. We're asserting the way we put out this news from the public. And I think this whole direction is going in a direction on YouTube and everything else, this whole social media. There is underground trying to suppress this stuff, and there's a competition getting the truth out. But what we're doing right now, and what we're doing is, it's you can't suppress it because it's live right now.
Exactly.
What are they going to do? They can't shut this stuff down. So.
Yeah. Yeah. And Blake, man, look, I love the fact that you're watching. Thank you for popping in. And like I said, I just want to make sure, because you were joining. I don't know who sent the pop up that said, hey, Third Phase, see if they want to come in, or Third Phase may want to come in. I assumed it was you when I first saw it. So I hope I didn't pressure you to jump in. So
no, absolutely. No, we didn't put out the word. But once that came up, we're like, well, is it really possible to join this hangout live? Well, why not? Why not? We like to talk to people live, and we saw that you were broadcasting live, and we said, hey, let's take a look at this. This is, I got my brother here, Brent's here, and we like to keep a tab on what's the ufology world, what they're thinking about. Because if it wasn't for the people like you, who's Dark?
Dark Wolf's dead.
Yeah, Dark Wolf. He's just a friend of mine who we've been talking a lot in the last few months, and he's got a like-minded perspective like you guys do, and we all kind of think the same, and we try to we try to get to the bottom of things and be as honest as we can. So he's just like me and you, just a good guy, and he has great points, and he's got a channel of his own. So
yeah, you got to have other people's reasoning behind things. If you're just a solo person out there claiming something, then that's a big burden to have. Like I said, the way we do things, we bounce off people's opinions of what this UFO phenomenon's all about, and then Unirock and this Dark Wolf, you guys are doing something special because it does take.
We gotta look through the trees.
You guys are looking through the trees and seeing the light at the end of the tunnel and trying to solve the mystery. When you were talking about the satellites earlier, and you're bringing up big questions like, why don't we see these satellites with our own naked eye? And why aren't these satellites being captured aboard the ISS? You would think it'd be like a plethora of just bright gleaming orbs everywhere. Definitely. If they were shooting this. So it is a definite legitimate question that you're asking. So if you don't mind, I'm going to ask that to my Third Phase of Moon viewers.
Sure, you're welcome to take anything and use it. Yeah, and like I want to also put out real fast, any time that you may see us live, if you email me, we'll have you on, because we'd love to have your view on a lot of our topics. So yeah, it would be great. You can take anything you see on my channel, anything you see on Dark Wolf, he's cool too. And
like I
mentioned, UFO Underground and some other of those guys we work with, they'd all love that, sir. Yeah.
Well, that's awesome, because I think if we could share videos, I got to get permission. Most people, when they submit videos to us, they really don't care who or what. They just want to get that word out and share to the world what they captured, and they have no problem. They have no problem just sharing it with anybody and getting their opinions, because they want to know what they captured. And I think that's important. I think we could do that. I definitely think we could share some footage and then share it with you and get real time reaction.
Oh yeah, sir. Yeah. Yeah. We just want to work with other people who just, are just regular guys. We all have families. We all like talking to the public. And, the mainstream doesn't give us that opportunity. And we have this great place where we can do this. And it's just a really good thing. I'm so glad you popped in today, and I'm really happy you accepted our invitation. What's your plans? I know it's probably late. Is it morning for you in Hawaii? What time is it over there?
Well, no, actually, it's about 9:30 9:30 p.m. So we're 3 hours. I don't know where you're based out of, but
Okay. Yeah, we're in the East Coast of the United States. So yeah, I was just off on my estimation.
So you're in the AM right now. It must be about maybe 2 or 3 AM right now.
Yeah, right. Yeah, you got it, sir. Yeah, well, we do it at all times. You know.
You guys are nuts. You guys are nuts. But that's cool. That's a, you know, you never know when people are tuning in.
That's true.
Hey, Blake, I must ask you, this is going to go up on my channel instead of Uni's when it's done. Do I have permission to go ahead and throw your name in the tag?
Oh, yeah, man. No problem. Absolutely. Sure. Yeah. No. Appreciate you asking. That's one thing I do appreciate, because there's a lot of people out there. Like you guys were talking about Facebook and YouTube. There's a plethora of just people that don't ask and take claim for videos that are out there. And that means a lot to me, just because you ask that simple question. Most people would just say yes, but at least ask, right?
Oh, exactly. Sure. I'm very respectful. That's one thing about me and Uni, you'll find we're extremely respectful when it comes to other people's stuff and, you know, asking usage and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah, and we know that you guys you've been on YouTube for a while. Do you mind if I just ask, like, you know, how long have you been on YouTube and how you got started? I mean, some of our viewers might like to know that, if you're cool with that.
Well, yeah, it's a long story, but yeah, I think we started this thing probably about 8 years now. It was really early on when YouTube just got started, and it's way before any kind of monetization or revenue was even existent on YouTube. But we felt that this was a platform that people needed to share in a community, because there was a big gap in the multimedia major conglomerate industry. There was sightings was basically the last thing we saw on the major media. And then all of a sudden there was just a gap. There were pretty much not going off UFO activity. So we started to ask some people, hey, have you seen anything from around the world in regards to the UFO phenomenon? We want to hear it. So we started this Skype thing, and even Google Hangouts wasn't even existed before Skype. So we were able to communicate around the world, just asking the simple question, have you captured anything? Submit it to us right here at Third Phase of Moon. And, you know, the rest just kind of snowballed after that. And it was quite exciting. So, yeah, you're looking at a video right now from Jimenez from Mexico City. This was captured a few years ago. But, yeah, I got to talk to the guy. I reached out. That's what I like to do in Third Phase of Moon. We reach out to some of the small guys, the smallest people out there. They want to get the word out, and Jimenez has a great YouTube channel.
Oh, great.
He got the word out, and he's been continuing his UFO channel for a long time, and he captures, and people submit him incredible stuff, and I think it was thanks to Third Phase Moon by putting him on the map. So, yeah, good. It's just the whole YouTube phenomenon and sharing videos and this whole thing, but now the world's caught up to this whole aspect. Now people are wanting to get on the bandwagon. And what I like about you is, like, you're giving credit where credit's due, and you just don't like share a video without having some background knowledge. And that's what that's the whole point of it.
Yeah, and I was impressed too that what you just said, because you just mentioned how there are a lot of smaller channels on YouTube and you give them a chance. And I'm telling you, the majority of YouTube has no, they have no thought there, you know, and it just says something about a person's character when they're willing to, you know, just like you are right now talking to us on my channel's been around about 2 months. We've got about maybe 600 subscribers, and it's cool that you cover the gambit of YouTube. It says a lot about you guys, and we do love what you guys do, and you guys have exposed a lot of topics in this community. And you're not discriminatory, which is good.
Exactly. You're looking at footage right now, and this is definitely controversial footage in regards to a paranormal action. But again, this is coming from Look Now TV. There's this guy named Rick, and he runs the Look Now TV channel. But then we speak to dozens of other channels. We just want to get the word out. Infamous, UFOs, Dr. Greer. It doesn't matter who you are, really, as long as people just want to talk to the people that are capturing this, who's reporting on this, who's got an open mind, and who, yeah, we have no prejudice against anybody in this phenomenon, this UFO phenomenon, trying to get the word out, because we're all in it together. We're just trying to find out what's really going on.
Absolutely. Blake, let me ask you another question. You brought something up just a moment ago, and it triggered a question for me. What we were kind of discussing this earlier. What do you think will happen when disclosure, if disclosure ever happens? If they come out and said, yes, aliens are real, they've been here for years, we're sorry we lied, do you think the public would go cuckoo like that one article mentioned, or do you think they'd really come out and say, you know what, we really don't care?
You know, that, absolutely, absolutely. 30% of the population will go cuckoo, and at that point it'll get a little dangerous, because 30% of people's to deal with 7 billion, it's going to get dangerous.
Pretty good
at
one number, point. Yeah.
Well, Blake, I want to ask you. Go ahead. Well, I just wanted to ask you real quick. When we started this, we had 3 questions from one of our viewers. I'll let you complete what you were saying. You told us what you thought on satellites. We just want to ask real quick. There was a viewer that asked us. They said they keep seeing a star by the moon. And I know you're in Hawaii. So have you seen a star by the moon that kind of just is always right up by the moon, and it seems to move with the moon instead of the sky? I wanted to work that in.
Absolutely.
There.
Absolutely. Yeah, we have the clearest skies in the world right here on the Big Island of Hawaii. And when we look up right now, it's been past few days, it's been raining. But on Easter Sunday, it was one of the clearest. It's really open sky over here, open night spectrum. And we have the best observatories on the Big Island of Hawaii, the Mauna Kea. And you have the Keck Observatory, the Subaru, and so many others. And they're here for a reason, obviously.
Oh, for sure, yeah.
So, yeah, we have the best guys. Yeah, there's a star next to the moon. I'm not sure if it, you know, I don't really concentrate on little specks or stars or these things on third phase, because we have a lot bigger things to go after besides a speculation. But yeah, there is a star next to the moon, obviously, that we see.
Yeah, and it came up, our viewer has been, just seeing it a lot, and he just wanted us to maybe, you know, ask around and see other parts of the world that could see it. And because to him, I guess, we take questions from a lot of people, too, and, you know, he just had he's kind of just loving it. So I'm glad you gave him that. He'll be so happy to hear your perspective there.
Well, I hope Blake, so. Man, I hope thank so. What do you think? Yeah. The question was what's going to happen if we have full disclosure and how we're going to deal with it as a human race?
Yeah.
Again, yes, I would love your opinion on this.
Well, yeah, I appreciate the question on that one, because that is the big question. And, you know, I think it's going to happen in our lifetime. It's going to happen sooner than we think. But the whole aspect of it, we might not even deal with it. Even myself is how it could get really scary. Because when you're talking about, let's just put it this way. If we knew that God existed and Jesus Christ really existed and we could prove this for a fact, mm-hmm. you know, we're all going to go to church tomorrow. Yeah. We're going to do if we could figure out how to be like a Jedi master and levitate things and have the power of the Jedi, we're going to be training forever, right?
I'd be in the temple right now. Are you kidding me?
Exactly. So we're all going to die happy if we could find this out, and nobody's going to have any problems with either of this. This is all good, because with the Jedi and this Jesus or whatever, there's an afterlife, so no big deal. But right. When it comes down to alien action, what if it's nothing like this? What if Would you die a happy man or a happy woman, people, if you knew that there's alien existence, but they're going to wipe us out? Is that going to be worth it? I'm not exactly sure, because there is that possibility that people warn us about, that, you know, we could be taken out, and what are we going to get out of it? Nothing, life ever after, and what else is, so now we're not alone.
Yeah. Yeah.
Maybe there's a reason why they're not telling us at the moment. And there are smart people in the government, higher echelon, that they might be doing it for a reason. Some people argue with me all the time, like, oh, no, there's no good guys in power. But maybe there is a good reason why they're not telling us. correct me if I'm wrong. I'm not sure, but
well, you are right there. And I, what you just said is so it's open. It's mind opening because I've not looked at that perspective when I think of disclosure about, you know, religion and what it will tell people. And that's probably the main reason why they will get panicked or, you know, they'll go into those deeper thoughts. So I that just really helped me out in understanding that whole perspective. I'm glad you said that for sure.
Yeah. If imagine you were, you know, it's hard to imagine if you're in charge of, well, let's just say if you were a trillionaire, how would you react at that point? You can't pretend to be somebody who you're not without knowing what it's like to be that person. And when somebody's in charge of this kind of a world that we live in, and there's, in my opinion, probably only about 12 of them that really are in charge. And again, I think Donald Trump has a little bit to do with it. Some people classify him as a top 38. He's in, out of 100, he's 38th in charge. I find that a little hard to believe, but you never know. Yeah. It's just,
you can't
pretend to be a rock star if you're not to know how you're going to act.
Exactly. Right.
I think he's got a little more power than some people give him. I don't think he has full reign by any means, but I think he's got a good bit of power to him.
Oh, yeah, with the changes we've seen in the world just since he's taken office, it's definitely evident.
Absolutely. Cool beard, dude. Cool beard, by the way, Dark Wolf. That's
awesome. I really appreciate that.
Yeah, he's our resident beard specialist. He's our beard specialist here at Uni Rock.
Yeah, you need to take some tips from him, Uni Rock. He's got it down.
I'm getting there. I'm starting to try. So he's teaching me the ways of the beard. So, you know.
I got to say, I love the red, man. I wish mine was red. I got the brown, but I love – well, I got the white and brown.
Yeah. Hey, I'm starting to get
it. Some people say they'd rather be dead than red, but that's other people's opinions.
That's right, because, hey, red is where it's at. You know what I mean? Well, hey, you know, what do you guys think about you know – oh, go ahead, sir. Yeah.
This was a – let me get to I just wanted to point out that Google Earth just came out with some really new stunning technology. And again, they might be making there's been many a times that people submitted us Google Earth imagery. And then when you go back to the coordinates after we posted it on Third Phase Moon and it's been viewed a million times, the images are retracted and they're replaced with other images. So it doesn't exist. We could prove this for a fact, but what's really cool is that Google Earth has come out with a 3D of a lot of the – you got to look it up, but we're taking a look at this, and there's going to be a really lot of new evidence that still has yet to be scuttled, in my opinion, as far as this new Google Earth 3D imagery. We flew over Area 51 recently. You might want to take a look at this with the new Google Earth and download.
Have you checked it out? Hangar.
You know, I haven't seen this new 3D thing in Google Earth, but I'm a big Google Earth user and I follow a lot of what people say on it. And I know that you know, some people say this new 3D stuff is gonna be what word am I looking for? It's gonna be a lot more. Help me out, Dark Wolf. It's going to be clearer. It's going to be a better to see the stuff we're looking at now. So I can see.
It's going to be a lot clearer.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Open up everything we're looking
at. Well, we actually flew over the Malibu anomaly of that underground water base.
Oh,
that base. And really? When we check that out on the new Google 3D, this is kind of breaking news. And you guys, if you guys want to break it and show it on this new Google Earth 3D platform, play around with it.
Oh,
you can capture some incredible imagery that's never been seen before on YouTube. So I'm giving it to you right now if you want to do the homework.
Okay.
We're going to be doing it real soon ourselves, but, man, it's a heads up to you. And
all
if
right.
you do it, yeah, just credit Third Phase Moon for taking a look at that. Revisit
Will
it
do.
Because it's really amazing imagery that's still undeniable with this new 3D imagery that they got going.
Yeah, we'll put that on. I've been taking notes ever since you came on, and I've got it down. We have any topic on this part of our show, so we'll bring it in and get onto that, and hopefully we'll all find some good stuff. That just seems like a really fantastic way to be able to look at things.
I can't wait to play with this new tool. I ain't seen it yet.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you're going to be up all night or all morning, man, playing with it because it's quite incredible, dude. It's you guys will be amazed. And again, Google could do their own things and imagery and scuttle things. But again, there are true facts and anomalies that pop up in it.
Well, in the beginning,
once it's in the beginning, they're going to make mistakes as usual.
There we go. That's what exactly. That's the good point to look at. For sure. Well, hey, we will get on that for you, man, and we'll definitely put you in his credit for it, and we appreciate that very much.
All right, guys. Well, send us in if you find anything cool. Let me know because we want to know. UniRock, appreciate it. We're gonna get going, but keep up the good work. Keep up the good work. We'll always want to entertain going down discoveries that you make, or we want to share discoveries on your channel. It's always good just to start out at a ground base, and I could see you guys up and coming, so appreciate it. Keep up the good work, guys.
Thanks, buddy.
Well, thank you, buddy. We appreciate. Yeah, I was going to say, we really appreciate you joining us, man. That's really great of you. I appreciate you letting me use this on the channel and joining us and giving us your insights. Like, your insights were brilliant, and I look forward to you coming back and joining us again as a guest, if you would like.
Yes, Blake, definitely.
Absolutely. Appreciate it, guys. And
all right.
Yeah, keep your eyes in the skies, obviously. Have a steady hand. Always good to have a steady hand. You want to keep that hand steady to get good footage. But
you know,
see you guys next time. Appreciate it.
All right. Thanks, Blake.
Thanks, Blake. Thanks for broadcasting.
Anytime. Well, isn't that just the coolest damn thing that's ever happened, Dark Wolf? Did you expect that?
Man, that was totally unexpected. For third phase, come in, man. That's like one of the more huge channels on YouTube. Can't talk to many people without them knowing about third phase.
Yeah, man, we got to be doing something right. And, man, he's just the friendliest, coolest guy. I know he's been interviewed. Well, see there, and I want to say this. I want to put this out there. I want to make sure I talk about it because I don't just go one way. We've had we had an issue on, and I've covered it. Now, I reported what happened on my channel. We had another channel that reported some things that happened when a recent debunking channel talked with Third Phase. Some bad things, not bad things. We'll just say it wasn't Third Phase's fault at all. Just some arguing happened, which is expected in that situation. We reported it. We will always report things like that on UniRock, and I'm so glad Blake came on and we got a chance to talk to him. And dude, it just opens up the perspective.
Great.
You know, it gives you a perspective on things.
Yes, his perspective on disclosure, especially. I've wanted to ask him that for a very long time, and his perspective was something. Definitely. That's something I'd never seen coming. He explained that in such a way that I've never heard anybody go before, and I've listened to a lot of them.
Oh, yeah, man. Oh, yeah. And the thing is, okay, so if we were to sit here and talk about other YouTube channels and say, like, and we just go through the gambit, we name channels off. A Third Phase does a show which is like a radio show, and he has a lot of different people come on. And just like, you know how Dr. Lupo will have people come on, they'll start talking, they'll say things about really extreme topics. You know, like, let's say in the UFO realm, I've heard somebody talk about on Third Phase reptilian aliens and undercover reptilian things. Okay. Now, I know a lot of people complain because they're like, why would you talk about reptilians on your channel and blah, blah, blah. I think, though, now I'm just going to put my opinion out there. I think that what Blake and you know, he just is basically having people on and letting them talk, just like we just did. So I have got to open my mind a little more and understand that when you have a guest and you let them speak their mind, because that's what you're going to do anytime you have someone on. You have
Absolutely.
To, if they have an extreme point of view, you shouldn't hold the YouTube channel itself. Because that's what's happened. I know. Exactly. Okay. Now, the reason I'm saying this, let me just put it out there. When a different channel contacted Third Phase, a lot of his followers got mad when he didn't ask certain questions that they wanted asked only because of what his channel did, okay? So his channel debunked UFO sightings. They wanted him to ask about UFO sightings and some of his footage and saying, hey, what's up with this? What's up with that, right? Well, that caused this big backlash and this big fight. We reported it. We got dragged into it a lot too. But here's the key part of all this, okay? In the end, though, everybody still tries to talk, get along, make things work. And I want to make sure that on every perspective that Unirock and I, when I was asked to look into that and when I reported on that, I want to always stay neutral and I always want to give a good opinion, okay? And it's just that I just have to put that out there, Dark Wolf. I don't know if you watched those episodes of my show, but I just had to put that out there.
I didn't watch those particular episodes, and now I kind of wish I had. Sounds exciting. But
well, you know, it was pretty cool, but the thing was that, and just like, you know, when we first came on and we started talking about, we want to stay positive. We don't want to have any type of conflict. We don't want to be people that, you know, let's say Unirock, right? When I did Mandela Effect stuff in the very beginning, I got a lot of people who came on and said, hey, you know, you got to be batshit crazy to believe in Mandela Effect. And I was responding to them like, look, man, I've already said a million times, this is what I believe about Mandela Effect. This is what I don't believe about Mandela Effect. Here's the issue. A lot of viewers don't care what you say you believe about a topic. As long as it's on your channel, you get held accountable. You know what I mean? You see what train I'm going? So like I said with the reptilian thing, it is possible that
That's exactly where you're going with this.
Okay, so yeah, if somebody got mad at Third Phase because they had, now I'm not saying reptilian, I'm just saying any content, you know, it's best to go ask Blake. You know, it's best to just talk to the guy, you know?
Right. Don't take other people's opinion. Hear it from the mouth of the horse. And he's clearly a cool, laid-back guy who's willing to give anybody an open ear. So, yeah.
Someone we are, too.
Go to the person. Oh, yeah, we are definitely like that.
You know. So I just want to, you know what I'm going to do, Dark Wolf, instead of sitting here complaining and talking and blabbing about this for another 20 minutes, I'm just going to make a video and just give my opinion. So I'll do that later.
There you go.
So what do you got going on? I know it's getting late. What do you got going on right now?
Yeah, I'm about to have to jump off here. I got to take care of some personal stuff.
Yep.
So let's end on a happy note. We appreciate everybody coming by to hang out with us tonight. This will be a regular thing. If you want to catch this stream again or you want to show your friends, it'll be on Dark Wolf's Den. I hope everybody's enjoyed. I've enjoyed the hangout. I've enjoyed the chat. We're going to make this a regular thing. Like he said, this will be as many times as we can do it. You know, we both do have regular lives, so we can't be on here all the time. But we will be on doing this as much as we can. We love you guys. We do it for you guys. And we hope you enjoy it as much as we do. What do you got, Uni?
All right. Thanks, Dark Wolf, man. You are so good at this. And this you've only live streamed a couple of times. It's amazing how good you are at doing this stuff, man. Okay, so what I want to go into real fast is just that we're going to take topics from you also. Find our email addresses. I'll add Dark Wolf's in mine too. Find our email addresses in the About section of our YouTube. Always make sure, not just with us, any YouTuber that you think does a good job, give them a like, give them a sub, and give them a share. Because that's how YouTube rates them. That's how we get our video put into the search results. So when someone types in a topic, based on how many people watch, like, comment, and share is how we get seen. Now, I just want to make sure, we won't say go into it hardcore on every episode. That's just how you got to do it if you want them to have more viewers and you want them to keep doing what they do. Also, the last thing I'm going to say, because me and Dark Wolf have been on here a while and my headphones are hurting my ears. I don't know about you, Dark Wolf.
But, mine too.
The only other thing I want to say is for the people who stuck around and watched us, thank you. A Third Phase has 400,000 subscribers and we just interviewed them. I mean,
right.
Dude. We are fucking going places, you know? I'm just playing. I know, you know, it doesn't mean we're going places. It just means, you know, that's really, thank you, Third Phase, is what I was trying to say. I was trying to be funny. But thank you for giving the little guys a chance like us because, you know, this is a community. And just because we might be smaller, I hope we can not disappoint bigger channels, not disappoint our viewers, and I hope we don't disappoint each other. Dark Wolf, I hope I'm always doing the right thing here for you, buddy. So we'll keep this up, man.
You're helping me out. You've helped me out from the beginning. I started my channel about 2 weeks or about a month after you did. I was about 2 weeks in when I contacted you. And, man, you've helped me from the very beginning. I appreciate everything you've done for me personally. we're making a great team here. I think we're really going somewhere. The fact that Blake joined us, man, that was awesome. Like, that tells me we're doing something right. If he actually, you know, he caught his attention. He was nice enough to even come in and excited about coming in and hang out with us. Like, that was awesome. We really, really appreciate you, Third Phase, Blake.
And the last thing, yeah, Blake and Brent, oh gosh, you guys. And I want to say one more thing. I'm sorry the outro is long this time, but I'm going to tell you guys something. And I don't get cocky that often, but we are going right up to the top. And the people who are good to us, we're going to take with us. And I'm taking Dark Wolf. I'm taking Third Phase. We're taking everybody. And we're going to do this forever, whether we have 1,000 subs or whether we have 20. So we will catch you next time on – what was the name of this? The hold on. I got Uni it right Rock- here. Uni Rockinati. That's what we'll call this, at least for a while. All right. We'll see you guys later. Dark Wolf, I'm going to message you in 2 seconds. I got to meet you in Hangouts just to round this out with you, if that's cool, buddy.
Excellent. Sounds great, brother.
All right. Well, we'll see you guys next time.